Nice. There's the Sony logo. That's Spider-Man. That's Spider-Man. They also make our. They also make the video editor that Jane Doe uses to edit our show.
Oh yeah,
because it's Sony Vegas. Now that we have two mics, Dale's just gonna be doing his own.
He's gonna like read a book and like just like be going through. He's gonna recite
the book. Since the dawn of time.
Welcome to the Dale Show.
Welcome to the Dale Show. Today we're going to talk about dinosaurs. That's right. I really like the T-Rex.
Sorry, guys. We're doing a lot of Trump jokes.
Welcome to the Dale,
just
friends.
Because of recent news.
What is the reporter's
Dude,
name?
Should we do some Biden jokes just to even out
it?
Our political...
Oh, so this is...
Even
this
out
is,
our politics.
Yeah, this is Marvel, right? So have you
shut
seen...
Up, man.
Will you shut up? My brain can only hold so much information.
Where okay, am I?
Go. Old Steve Rogers. Have you seen the comparison between old Steve Rogers and Joe Biden? It's really close.
Notice that angle they have the car in the frame? That's a commercial.
Oh, yeah.
That is a commercial, no doubt about it. Welcome back, guys, to the Cinematic Fanatics. Today we are watching Spider-Man Far From Home. And it's super sick and awesome, and we're going to have fun.
I'm back. Was I ever gone? I don't know.
Yes, Ben was gone. Wait.
When were you going?
No, I don't think I was ever gone in a I was never missing a video. I just couldn't participate in.
We never recorded out without Ben, but he got seriously sick.
Yeah.
And so we've missed him.
It's Mysterio, Fishbowl Man.
Yeah.
Except he doesn't have a fishbowl right now.
If only I was a comic book fan who would have known Mysterio was a villain from the beginning.
Oh, dude. Well, the problem is I saw the memes of this, so I already knew he was like a... He was like a turned villain, so
you
I was
got
like,
spoiled.
Which I was like, why is he the good guy right now? And then I was like, wait a minute. Oh, there's gonna be
wait,
a transition.
What's the song is called?
Oh, Whitney Houston's.
It's the tribute to Tony Stark.
Oh, yeah!
Who is also the star in the next movie we're watching today.
Oh, yeah, that's funny. I think you're doing the Titanic song.
We'll always love power and money.
And I, E.I., will always love you.
Ooh, woo, woo.
This is such like a high school video editing.
Job. Oh, yeah. This is like one of my favorite scenes is the part where they cut to the high school.
Yeah. Oh, and look at that king. Oh, it's so true.
Like an American hero.
How much you want to bet you can actually find these pictures on Google?
I think they did that intentionally.
Getty images right there.
Yeah, see?
Oh, boy.
It's so true, though.
My background on my school Chromebook used to be a stock image of a dude holding lettuce.
Oh, I just got rid of Willem Dafoe.
What? Willem DeFamily?
Yeah. Do you want to see the new picture? It's like the cutest thing of my cousin.
Including our own Midtown
High. Oh my goodness.
She's wearing the headphones.
What?
I was showing her. Cool. Yeah, she is the sweetest.
Oh. They called it. I forgot about
the blip. The blip.
What is this? One of those TikTok trends?
Yeah, like my little brother is now older than me.
Yeah, it's math. And even though we had booked away...
Oh, dude, you can see the microphone overhead. Yeah. Wait, I want it to cut out so you can see the microphone again.
Boom, mic people.
Yeah!
They capture it so well.
Professionals have standards.
Dude, this is...
So, ironically, this video quality they're showing us here for them is better than our own
school. I was going to say, no offense to our school, I really like... this is way better than our schools.
They've got one guy doing all the work, and the rest of the class does nothing.
They're like, that one dude just slaving away.
I was in that class, and I was like, yeah, I'm going to learn some video editing stuff.
And then you like, do nothing.
Nobody taught me anything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, nobody enforced any kind of work. And the guy who knew how to actually do things, he was too busy making the daily announcements to help me.
Oh, yeah.
But not even the teacher helped you?
The teacher just sat there and, like, I guess played on her computer.
I think I know the teacher you're talking about, yeah.
She, well... I know she's a lot more involved in, like, the yearbook and photography, so she does work. She just doesn't do work in that one class, which was really disappointing.
Look at all this Iron Man art in the background.
Well, because he's a new American hero. Like, he's... Yeah. I guess he did save the universe, after all.
And you know, this is a universe where all of the comic book nerds live in the comic book.
Yeah, yeah.
And so they're just like, heck yeah, this is my reality now.
Well, because, wait a minute, I just realized that, so Mysterio made up the fact that he's from another Earth.
Yeah.
So, like, technically, like, he wasn't even from Earth, whatever.
He's just an inventor.
He was just, like, he's like,
just an inventor.
This is like Incredibles, because the kid like invented all that stuff to make him super.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, Syndrome?
Yeah, Syndrome created all
and
the stuff.
And when everyone's super, no one will be.
all dramatically, too, like it's a really well-delivered line.
I just...
Oh.
No one will be.
That's
overall, Incredibles, one of my favorite movies.
Oh, yeah. It's so good.
Yeah. I think that's
Did
like...
you like the second one?
Not as much. I thought it was okay.
I thought it was okay.
I thought the animation was pretty sweet.
Well, yeah, because it's more like
I loved that they like gave Jack more than one power.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, he's the most powerful one.
He's hybrid baby.
Grows up. You know what they used to call me? They used to call me the hybrid baby.
I was
going to
say, that sounds like, he's like, you know, people say, that's America, baby. That's the hybrid
our
baby.
Our school system is currently like, I don't have any full-fledged ideas. Here's the
it's
hybrid
baby.
Baby.
Here's the hybrid baby.
Yep.
Potentially, we're going to go back to online.
Oh, well, yeah.
Oh,
our
definitely.
State
I think
is in the red.
I'm betting end of the month. We're going.
I'm betting tomorrow.
Tomorrow, you think?
Dude,
oh, well, wait, tomorrow.
That would be so unfortunate. That would be so unfortunate.
I think next week. Next week, we're in the clear. I think it's the week after we're worried about. What'd you say?
I was sick, so I didn't go to school the past week. Not
oh,
like,
yeah, you're
not like
about
COVID
that.
Sick, but like.
Yeah, you were just more
yeah.
feeling well, so you don't
yeah.
want to scare people.
Yeah. So I was like, I'll stay home, I'll do the Zooms. In the
yeah.
afternoon,
yeah,
which still technically counts as me being in school, so it's fine.
Yeah,
I'm going to a technical school now where I'm actually learning video editing stuff, like for Premiere. And so I cannot do it from home though because they gave me a MacBook Pro, which is super cool by
oh,
the way.
Oh, there's my boy John Favreau.
There he is.
Yeah, John Favreau.
Thank you. He's my hero.
He's a little.
He's really happy.
Oh,
in this
his
movie,
his
actually.
Blip beard.
Yes.
His blip beard.
Yeah, my blip beard.
Freaking love that.
What's her name? Melissa Tomei.
Mrs. Tomei. Aunt May.
Marissa Tomei. Aunt
Do
May.
Not bring
happy.
It up.
What? You mean inside jokes?
Yeah, don't bring up inside jokes. Also, he kind of goes like, I thought he was a little weird, this one, like in this scene, where he's just like, oh, here you go. He's like scared. He's like a shy boy.
I mean, yeah, she's happen? The dominant one. Let me tell you about it.
Let me tell you.
Now I tell you, say.
Oh, dude, every time I do that, like, get a weird
right,
feeling in
my
jaw.
What? Got a weird feeling in your jaw, hey?
What'd you say?
What?
I got a weird feeling in my. I thought you said I got a weird feeling in my jaw. Right?
Oh, I got it again.
You're my jaw. Why don't you want to talk to him? It's like how to say stuff.
You sent Nick Fury. You know what? I'm gonna call him. No, I can't say this on the podcast.
Wait. Oh yes.
Okay.
Dang, you're not.
It wasn't like inappropriate or anything. It's just I'll make a joke about a person I know that might offend them if they watch. I don't know. It might. Oh, look at that plate. You see that plate mask?
Oh,
so much effort.
Plate masks. 10 out of 10.
Oh my gosh, flashing lights. Come on. Come back. What are you going to do? Does anyone have any neighborhood questions? I don't like it when movies do that. It like freaks me out. What is it like to take over from Tony Stark? Which is what they're wanting, but
yeah, I was going to say.
Oh. That's intense. Is this something they're going to explore more in Homesick, especially when they all know who he is in Homesick?
Wait.
Cause like,
is it his identity? I thought he just
in the ending credits, we get a cameo from J. Jonah Jameson,
played by J.K. Simmons. He's
yes.
back, baby.
Oh, I
he was in
that.
He was in Tobey Maguire.
Awesome we should watch it when we like.
Oh yeah, you'll see it. You'll see it.
I
but he essentially
love J.K.
says
Simmons.
That Mysterio left a death message saying that Spider-Man was
like how we're spoiling.
Peter Parker.
It's Peter Parker.
Yep, and so everybody knows at the end of this movie who he is. And so they kind of establish in the opening of this movie this fear of large crowds.
Yeah.
Because they're exploring his kind of fear of being in charge.
And also,
he has to
like,
go through and accept that.
Like, he knows that Iron Man's shoes are really big. Like, he has big shoes to fill.
But in the next movie, he's going to have to explore being a celebrity. Because that is a really, really hard change to have forced on you like that.
I was going to say, how is a friendly neighborhood Spider-Man? Like, you know.
And now I'm...
And now, like, everyone's in my house, you know? I don't
pretty
like
sure
it.
He had his, I'm pretty sure he had his identity revealed in the comics.
You know what? I'm sorry.
I slouched down a little bit.
Don't slouch, Ben. Straighten your back. Sit up.
Thanks, Mom.
Sorry, we're trying to...
You're welcome, sweetie!
We're adjusting to our new dual microphone setup, and we're a little too comfortable, because we want to make sure the audio quality comes out good. Did that say
BFP?
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Ben Parker.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Because they never actually show Ben dying in this one.
Yeah, but he did.
He did. It's kind of the thing. It's one of those things where I don't like to watch it over and over again.
I mean, it's
every,
a really...
like, reboot of a superhero movie. I don't need to watch their backstory every time.
Yeah, that was a really smart thing that they did for these movies.
I'm trying to think.
Skip the exposition. You all know the story. This is the most popular comic book character of all time.
Yeah.
You know what's gonna...
Yeah. I don't need to watch Batman's parents get
murdered. I was gonna say, they did have
in the alley, like, every team.
They did have the Batman games, kind of. Like, they didn't start from when he was a kid, but there was, like, flashbacks of, like, in the alley and stuff, which I kind of like, instead of having to go from kid Bruce Wayne to, like, fully adult. Beating up Mr. Freeze, Mr. Wayne.
Okay, so another thing is, since you're facing that way, your wavelengths are really small, so I'm going to face this way.
How are mine doing?
You're just going to have
to.
What about if I just go like this?
There's so much... That's better.
Yeah.
There's so much couch to explore. But I'm...
I was like, dang, we can actually have more of a podcast now. We're just laying out.
Am I doing okay?
Well, you're on there.
You're on there, and you're doing fine, because you're facing forward. We checked.
I was going to say, yeah.
In fact, you might be a little too loud now. I'll fix it.
Too much power.
This is an exploration.
Unlimited power.
Man.
Unlimited power. Ah, moisturizer, please.
You want to
moisturize me. Moisturizer.
You want to know something I did last night that I didn't really want to do, but my mom really wanted to do it? Mm-hmm. Was she wants to watch all the Star Wars movies, like what we did, but like, so every Friday we watch one Star Wars movie, right?
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. 9 weeks of Star Wars.
We started last week, episode one. Episode two, we watched it last night, and I was like, oh my goodness.
Remembering all the...
I got, like, flashbacks of, like, the scene when they're, like, on the balcony. And then you go... It's just, like, you yelling to go, ah! Like, when he touches her back. And I'm just like, oh, my goodness.
Yeah, watch that video. It's hilarious. Also, there's, like, the marriage thing. And, like, we're talking about his, like, his silver arm. And they're like, oh, it's so cold. You should get some moisturizer.
I don't think that's when we did, that's not when we did podcasting, so we didn't get everything in, but I think I remember that. That wasn't in the
video.
That
got into the final episode.
That did?
It was just the very last thing.
Okay, because I remember seeing that in the best of, and I was like...
It's in there. Go check it out.
Oh, you have a dual headphone adapter. We can watch together.
I have one of those.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. Our flight time today will be 8 hours and 49 minutes to Venice.
Wait, so isn't it like technically like 2023?
Yeah.
Yeah, because like
they're
takes...
quickly getting ahead of us.
Yeah.
High definition. High def.
Oh, it's kind of
louder sounds. Oh, and she's just looking at him. She's thinking, oh,
bro, is that the future of airplanes? Like, where
that's
you just like
nerd.
Where you just play your PC games on an airplane? That'd
I'm down.
Awesome.
What? That's not an accident, dude.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
And she's okay with it.
She just, dude. I would get. Sorry.
Oh my gosh.
I'm still like, oh my goodness.
That is genuinely sweet, though.
Dude, 2023.
Awesome. Yeah, luckily she blipped, too.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, I just... But she didn't go... Or did, wait, is she well, 5 years older?
He blipped. And so he skipped those 5 years, and if she hadn't blipped, she would have been 5 years older than him. So she has to have blipped. So, Ned has to have blipped.
That's the thing I didn't understand. So if you snapped and you disappeared,
all three of these characters that we're seeing again had to have blipped.
So like, yeah, they all disappeared.
Yeah.
And then they all came. That's so weird.
I hate couples like that.
Yeah.
What was that?
Don't worry, they last like 2 or 3 weeks. It's okay.
See, I kind of see. I mean,
I love you because you poke my nose.
This happened.
I love America because they poke my nose.
I have poked America's nose.
When you go, and they love it. When you go into America, the TSA pokes you on the nose to make sure that you're okay to travel. Guess what? At the inauguration, they poked my nose. I will not be at the Biden inauguration because I think he's stupid. I will not poke
He will
his
not
nose.
Poke my nose.
Hashtag do not poke my nose.
Don't read in
they're like with AK-47s and he's
I know,
like,
right? The comedic imagery in this is so good. I love how good the
oh, yeah.
in these movies are.
That's the thing you can't bring on play, like, or you can't like bring is like fresh fruits like bananas. Yep. You can't bring?
Yep. Shut up, air conditioner.
Wait a minute.
Get your own banana.
You just showed us that they won't hear it.
Oh, well. The loud... It gets loud sometimes compared to it being quiet.
Yes.
Shows up. Mm-hmm. And people notice.
Oh, is that the Taj Mahal?
What?
No.
No!
You're the history guy, Ben.
No, I'm kidding. It's Venice. Ah, oh, just like Indiana Jones, 3.
It's Venice.
Venice! V-nice!
Hey, everybody, oh I just goodness. Wanted to tell you to V-nice.
Hey, V-nice to people! Come on!
You
want
you
to do
know
it!
Never know if karma's gonna come around and bite your Venice off.
Hotel, spelled H-O-T-E-L.
What about...
Hotel!
What about if, like... What about... What about if, like, a segment in this movie was, like, they just, like, are shooting Indiana Jones and The Last Crusade, and so there's just, like, Indiana Jones, like, running around Venice in, like, a boat?
Sean Connery shows up.
This belongs in the museum. This belongs in the museum. I haven't seen all those
so
movies.
So do you!
Yeah.
You know my
the first
favorite one?
In Temple of Doom.
I really like the Crystal Skulls with Shia LaBeouf.
I don't like that one. That's my least favorite one.
The Crystal Skulls is in... What the Crystal Skull vodka is based off of?
Dan Aykroyd.
Yeah,
Dan Aykroyd.
I watched the Beloved classics.
I really need to watch those.
I watched that John Chong episode when I was in.
Want to watch them on the show?
I just like yeah. Isn't I'm like 20 minutes, like 15 minutes.
Oh no, I'm not talking about Dan Aykroyd.
Oh, you're just talking about Indiana Jones.
I'm talking about Indiana Jones.
I would be
good video and all, but not a cinematic video.
Yeah, I was gonna say we should
which
also
is our area.
I also want to watch Pirates of the Caribbean if we get the chance.
Oh yes.
At least like the first. I don't know. I don't know if we should do them all.
Yeah, I don't know. Comment below what you want us to watch, please.
Them again,
what?
I started watching them again because you know.
What's
Johnny
your favorite?
Depp is pretty neat.
Yeah, he is pretty neat.
Oh.
I said that internet. Sorry. For all those people. Actually, it's not even like the internet people. The internet's like liking Johnny Depp. It's like,
yeah.
Just
yeah. For some
WB,
reason,
basically.
People are supporting Amber Heard for some reason.
Not
much. Yeah.
Just because, like, she could be telling the truth.
She could be.
It's just likely that she is.
What's weird is that it's still in dispute. I think we already went over this in our episode.
I heard that she said she was going to. Give the money that she got from the trial to charity.
I mean,
and then she didn't.
There's a difference between saying. I was like, there's a difference between saying something and actually doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is the whole point of this case, because a lot of people said things.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean they did things. So yeah, I don't know. I'm going to wait and see before I say anything online.
Online.
Because you never know. It could be a mistake.
I do think Johnny Depp, like, as a person, is just a... Like, as an actor, I guess, not as a person. As an actor, he's just a unique individual.
Oh, yeah. Like, look at the things he's done. Pirates of the Caribbean. Nice. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
There you go. Pirates of the Caribbean. That's it.
Sweetie Todd.
Sweetie Todd. Great one right there.
Shark Factory.
Sweaty Todd.
Sweaty Todd.
That's my favorite.
Alice in Wonderland.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yas.
Oh, those crabs.
What did you say about crabs?
Did we miss
crabs?
Oh, we missed about Bo.
Yeah.
That was some really, really well done character work there.
Yeah. I like how she's like a fake, or not fake, like, she like has like this character she puts on for other people, and then like at the end you almost see like her true self is like, you know, this whole time I was just, you know, I was just cool.
Yeah, like that personality like type is that they intentionally separate themselves from people because they're afraid of getting hurt.
Which
is a thing they might explore more as like we get to know her in the next movies, because
We
didn't really talk to her much. He was just working up the courage to talk to her throughout this whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Well, also in the first one, like, we just see her like off and on.
Yeah. They show her a little bit because they know she's important and intentionally frame her in so many shots to show you she's important. It's really cool the way they thought of this. They thought of it like a trilogy. And if they keep the same staff of writers, I don't know how many there are, the next movies are going to do well. There's probably going to be a fourth and a fifth. This series could go on forever.
Tom Holland forever.
I mean, it really could.
Is that what the last one's going to be?
Yeah, exactly.
Tom Holland forever. Spider-Man.
Spider-Man forever.
Spider-Man forever. There you go.
Spider-Man Returns.
That's like
Spider-Man
Eternal.
Forever.
I just want to keep.
They steal the subtitles of the old
puns.
Batman movies.
Batman. Yeah, it's Batman. Batman
Spider-Man
Returns.
The Killing Joke.
Spider-Man the Killing Joke. There's Batman. Batman Returns. Batman Comes Back. Batman.
Spider-Man.
Batman
the
stays
Doom.
For a while.
Batman stays. Batman leaves.
Batman goes
guys,
on vacation.
Batman goes on vacation.
It gets
Spider-Man.
Into like child book, like different story.
Spider-Man, the Temple of Doom.
Spider-Man, Temple of Doom. Batman Chevy Chase edition.
Spider-Man, Rocky 3.
Dude, Spider-Man.
I got all the Rocky movies today, and I'm happy.
Spider-Man in
Wait,
space.
Isn't there four? I thought you said you got four.
I did. I got four.
Oh, I heard you said you got all three of them.
Wow, you're like a tenth of the way there.
What?
No, I'm not.
From what?
There's four.
From all the Rocky movies.
No.
There's not ten.
Forget what? Anything after four.
I okay.
I there is
care.
Rocky five.
I
there's
was,
Rocky.
I know there's not
five,
40, but I wanted to
is
make
there
that
six?
Joke.
Is there six?
Rocky Balboa.
There's like eight Rocky.
Is
yeah,
six, is
yeah.
Six
Rocky one.
Yeah, Rocky.
They didn't have one, but
Rocky,
it was Rocky,
Rocky,
Rocky 2, Rocky 3, Rocky 4, Rocky 5, Rocky Balboa.
And then Creed and Creed 2.
Yes.
Rocky Road.
Rocky Road.
Ice cream.
It's the Jester! That's an actual character.
Oh.
I don't remember where the Jester is from, but I think it's Spider-Man.
Whoa.
So that's a funny reference.
Mysterio is polluting
Am I wrong about
with
that?
His green, gas. Why isn't I feel like green gas is like a
my Venice has a disease.
Okay.
If you or your loved ones have
Venice.
Contracted Venice disease.
Venice disease.
You may be liable for
you may be liable for a good sum of money, you'll get to poke my nose.
You may be
that's
liable
worth
for
a lot
legal
of money.
Compensation.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Down the hall, take a left. To the
down hall, to left, go right now. Oh, I just got your reference.
It's
because of Home Alone 2.
Yes, thank you.
I think that was my favorite Home Alone movie.
Honestly, yeah. I liked the second one better.
Air conditioner,
wrong.
Chill out. It's weird. Home Alone. Home Alone's a weird like franchise.
Dude, that one had Tim Curry in it.
We're like one.
I forgot about
that. Where like one was like we're starting out something, and it was like kind of like a not a cliche thing, but like a.
I got news on the 24th of December that a movie, what's Deadpool's name again?
Deadpool?
Ryan Reynolds. I forget things like this
I was
going to
say Ryan Gosling, but that's not him.
Ryan Reynolds is directing a movie called Stoned Alone.
Uh-huh.
And it could potentially be starring Macaulay Culkin.
Oh, okay.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
It's an R-rated comedy, either starring Ryan Reynolds or Macaulay Culkin. It's not decided
or both.
Yet. But the movie is in development.
I heard at some point he was going to remake Clue.
Oh, really? Ryan Reynolds?
Yeah.
That would be fun. Especially
Granted,
if
it was like a rumor. So I don't
if they
know.
Took a comedy standpoint, that'd be a really good movie.
Did you guys see, I don't think you ever played these games, but did you see that, like, the Uncharted movie finished production?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like,
I never played the game.
It has Tom Holland, Mark Wahlberg.
Whoa.
Those are
big names.
Yeah, they're big dudes on this.
big dudes.
Not calling Tom Holland a big dude.
He's
actually a very fit dude.
Yeah.
You're a big dude.
He is.
He's very fit dude.
He does his own stunts, the guy. He's ripped.
It's like Mark Hamill.
Like me.
Yeah, with his, how many push-ups a day? 40.
40.
Not
40.
He did 40. Sit-ups.
On this podcast, I'm going to do a triple somersault.
A triple somersault? We need a camera.
I did it.
Oh,
good job.
No camera needed.
Yeah, it was really cool, right?
You
want to
see me do it again?
I did it! Whoa! I can't believe I nailed it twice in a row! You want me to do it a third
That's
time?
Like,
I'm on
what's
a
What's it called when you've done six of something?
I'm on fire!
A sextet?
Okay, I can't
believe
it.
I can't believe it.
I just did a sex. Tuplet.
Sextet. I think sextet is it.
Sextet? No,
that's
sex
when you do like six.
Okay, I did one of the sex. I did one. Well, six. Sorry.
A sixette? A sex pet.
You know, the
a
sex
six pack.
A six pack.
You got a six pack.
I did it on the show. Everybody saw it.
Everyone saw it.
Except you guys, the audience, but.
We saw it.
See?
And it was cool.
There, oh my. Is he eating spaghetti?
There's my man.
He's here. Oh no, he doesn't. Ew. Hanging around the office. And he wants to say
hi. Hi, Peter. Hey, Hoppy.
That's what I like about Jon Favreau. He's like a cool guy, he's a cool director. Cool actor, cool guy.
I really do like the character of Happy.
Yeah, he's cool.
It's really good.
Also, what a freaking cool name. Happy? Happy Hogan? Happy Hogan.
Yeah, Happy Hogan.
I don't know if cool is the word.
I guess a happy name?
It's an awesome name.
Swagalicious
name?
Yeah,
let's go with awesome.
Oh, okay.
Did you say Swagalicious
name? Swagalicious name?
Okay, you're not allowed to say Swagalicious.
Oh, sorry.
Can I say Swagalicious?
You can say Bootalicious. What
is it? Can I say
Bootalicious?
Yeah, is that the butt thing, awesome. Right? Okay. Sorry, booty.
No, that's booty.
Sorry, I pronounced it wrong.
Can I call the Grand Budapest? The Grand Budapest.
Sorry, that was the Buddhism thing. Bootalicious.
Bootalicious. Man, Siddhartha Gautama is so bootylicious. Or no, dang, I messed it up.
Dang it! I messed it up.
Wait, is it? So it's. It's, wait, boot, boot.
Buddha.
Bootalicious. Bootalicious.
That's the Buddhism one.
Siddhartha Gautama is so bootalicious. Because he's the Buddha.
Oh my gosh.
He has achieved nirvana.
Nobody be offended, please.
Nirvana, like the band?
No!
You know, I was trying to fact check ourselves in the last video about what we said about Zendaya Coleman.
Yeah.
Because I said she got an Emmy for Greatest Showman, but that was not correct.
No,
she got
Euphoria.
Euphoria.
That's a TV show.
Yeah, and when I was trying to research, I could not find her last name. Like, it took a very long time.
I don't think it's... Is it Coleman?
Yes, it is Coleman. She has a longer name, but I only took the last one.
I was going to say, I don't think her, like, real name is... I think it's, like, her stage name.
It
is
her real... It's a real name.
Oh.
But, like, she asks... Her last name is not put in movie credits.
Okay.
Like, she's put as Zendaya.
Zendaya and everything.
In these movies, which I thought was really interesting.
I always thought it was just, like, a one-name thing. Like,
I thought that was
like
just
Cher.
Yeah, well,
I thought that was just her stage name.
I researched further to give her a last name in our last video when we did the ding ding. And remember that effect where when we brought up her character, I put the actor name with an arrow pointing to the actor?
I don't remember that.
You don't remember that? Well, I tried to give her a last name and it took a while. I thought that was interesting.
What took more, finding the last name or the edit?
The last name actually took longer. I had to like go into Wikipedia.
You had to go into Jane Doe's office and say, Jane Doe, how much time did you use?
And like I had to like Google what is Zendaya's last name, and it would automatically like the first question that would show up is Zendaya's boyfriend. And I was like, no, last name, because I don't know. That's not a thing that shows up with male actors, if you notice.
What?
It's always the female actors. Like, that the most common question that people ask Google is boyfriend. Who?
Oh, really? I thought it was, like, there'd be a lot of people who are just like, this just like, name, wife, or whatever. It's just like,
is she single? Is there a chance? No.
Is there
Why are you
chance?
Asking Google this?
She's like, I mean, she's in like the Hollywood circle. I don't think you really.
I did learn that she started out as a Disney star.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Same as she was on a TV show about dancing. It was called
Dance Dance.
Revolution. Dance Dance Revolution.
Dance. All right, well, it's your stage. Guys, stop asking Google actresses' boyfriends. It doesn't make sense.
You don't have a chance.
Even though I did look Daisy Ridley's boyfriend on the show a while back.
Here's a little tip for y'all. Okay? I'm getting texting. Here's a little tip for y'all. So, you don't need... You don't need these famous people. You just live your life, go out, and you don't have to find. You can just, you'll just stumble across somebody that has the same likes and interests as you.
They're still finding it!
They'll be in the street.
Take them home.
You just go along with your life. You're going to
meet
someone.
Give them a little beef broth.
Make them a nice...
Make sure they're all fed and warm.
Ravioli.
Fat and warm. I don't know where we're going
with
this.
I said fed and warm.
Anyway, actual PSA. You don't need. Just because you see them in a movie doesn't mean they're gonna like you. And also, you don't know. You don't know if you're gonna even like them.
Just because you see them in a movie doesn't mean they're gonna like you.
Just go out and find someone that I don't know. You just gotta.
Ben's life
I like
advice.
Your PSA.
Just
yeah, my
you
PSA
see
is
doesn't
you
mean
don't
they're gonna
need
like
anyone.
You.
My PSA, the one that works better and is more marketable.
You can call me.
All you need to do is be yourself. You don't need another person to complete you.
You know what? That also. Well,
man, we're so sweet.
Yeah. Also, Jake Gyllenhaal has a nice beard.
Yeah, he does.
That's my the end of PSA.
Pass me my coffee, Dale. I beg of you.
Where's it at?
It's over in the shadows.
Oh, it's over there.
My coffee's in the League of Shadows.
I was raised in the coffee. You're saying that's the multiverse?
It's like Lord of the Beans.
Dude,
the
that song
tales.
Amazon.
Really?
It's on the IMDb TV.
Oh my god! I feel like
a lot
like,
of the VeggieTales stuff is. Sorry.
That's like kind of stuff that's like, oh my goodness.
Whoops.
There sorry, we go. That should be the fine. Table tilted. There we go.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh crap!
What have I done?
No!
Guys, you're not seeing I use VLC, even though that is the best software. Please use VLC.
We're not sponsored.
It has so many codecs, yo!
This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow
Legends. Man, I wish.
You know, not VLC.
Honestly, Raid Shadow Legends is actually. It's
that's
fairly
like,
good.
That's like a. That's like upcoming YouTube starter pack, Raid Shadow Legends.
That or NordVPN.
Or NordVPN.
Yeah, everyone's sponsored by NordVPN.
I don't use the VPN, but I just like the concept of like everyone uses it, even though.
It helps you get more things out of Netflix, is what I've heard.
It does, yeah. Because they have. Netflix has different things
depending
on
where you live. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So
there's certain
change,
things you can't watch in the UK that you can watch in the United States.
You can change what
versa.
Country your computer is in, and Netflix believes it.
VPNs are cool.
And it will be in approximately 48
hours. Yeah.
I don't use it.
Yeah.
Because it costs like $10 a month.
Not if you get the free trial.
I'm sorry, did you say
that? That only lasts like a month.
It only lasts 30 minutes.
And we only record I guess we do try and record like
you get
every
a new
week,
email,
but,
and then you use your new email to get the free trial again. And then you make a new email and
you
use that.
Criminal scum.
Don't actually do that.
The highest class of criminal.
Isn't that technically like a type of fraud?
What?
Technically,
yeah.
I'm sure it is.
Yeah,
don't actually do that.
Well, I bet like...
Pay money, don't be cheap. Don't be a Mr. Krabs.
And yes, they can track your IP address.
Oh. What, VPNs?
Yeah, VPNs. They track you.
So he says he's in Southeast Asia, but he's actually in India.
I guess they do track you.
Wait a minute!
What was that example?
He says he's in Southeast Asia, but he's actually in India.
He says he lives in California, but he's actually in the U.S.
California is like becoming its own thing, man. I don't know.
What are you guys' thoughts on Genghis Khan being canceled?
What are your thoughts? What? Canceled?
You guys not hear
about
that?
About the historical figure?
Yeah.
Or like the band? You know, there's an 80s band called I think it's called Genghis Khan.
Cool.
It's just spelled weird. It's like
guys who are trying to cancel Genghis Khan. He's dead.
He's been dead for over 300 years.
He's been canceled in the most efficient way.
I was gonna say, if you brought him, if you brought him here, he'd be like, "Hello, what's the computer, and why is everyone like?"
Goes back in time to witness Genghis Khan's death.
A lot of
you've been canceled.
A lot of people are trying to cancel Christopher Columbus, even though it's been even longer since he died.
Yeah.
But that makes more sense since he's celebrated as a holiday.
What do you mean it's been longer since he died?
Genghis
Khan died in like before.
He died like a minute before Christopher Columbus. Yeah. And then it's like, what do you guys mean Christopher Columbus died before?
Khan's like 500 years old.
Dale said like 300 years.
I'm pretty sure it's been over like 300 years.
Genghis Khan has been dead for like 2,000 years.
Which is over 300 years. I mean, if I said it was over 2 years ago, you wouldn't say I was wrong.
Do you guys see that, like, modern estimates for, like, the amount of humans that have ever lived is, like, 10 billion?
That's good.
Yeah.
I guess. I don't know if
you
that's
mean
cool.
Only, like, 4 billion more than
I was gonna say.
I mean, 2. Because right
is it
now
really
we're
8 billion?
At 8 billion now.
Are we 8 billion? We're 8 billion now?
Oh, we're at 8 billion subscribers!
8 billion!
That'd be funny 8 if,
billion
like,
potential subscribers.
That'd be funny if, like, you know the whole PewDiePie versus T-Series thing? If, like, for some reason one of the channels, like, just decided to, like, subscribe every YouTube account ever to their one of their channels, and so like it's just a big hack.
Introducing the glasses.
Oh yeah,
an important element in this movie.
You know about these glasses? We could.
Do
have,
you
like,
think they use glasses to mirror the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man scene where he's like?
No, these are a very different style. Stand by for retinol and biometric scan.
Retinol and biometric scan accepted. Hello.
Hello. I can do this
Peter
forever.
Party pooper. Tony Stark's
augmented reality security system. I like how, like...
Dale,
they can't
see. Glasses farther away, my head turns into a pin.
Oh, yeah.
You see it?
Yeah.
It's pretty neat, right?
Well, actually, I can barely see it because I can't see without my glasses.
Oh. So you need to wear glasses to look through the glasses in order to actually do that properly.
Yeah.
That's it. We're getting you a second pair of glasses.
Let's just get bifocals.
He used to have glasses that folded.
History of witchcraft?
Whoa. Oh, yeah. He's the witchcraft guy. It's like, you know what this is? This is witchcraft.
Oh, and look, did you see flashes in the background?
Why?
Mother, I have not heard from you. It's father. I have not heard from you in days.
Oh, my goodness. That's terrible.
I know.
Oh, my gosh.
Dude, that's they're funny. Sitting right next to each other.
That's the joke.
That is a major invasion of privacy.
Oh, yeah.
It
definitely.
Is.
Well, there's like a point where he's like, the dude, I forgot
you know
what his name is,
them?
Is like texting Zendaya.
NordVPN?
No.
I don't
Whoa.
Think it actually
It will
would
protect
work.
You from Tony Stark and his cronies.
In Austria,
cronies?
They have,
I said cronies.
Oh, no, cronies. What?
Cronies.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Cronies. That's
cronies?
What I'm saying.
Cronies?
Cronies!
You got crow's knees?
Did you touch that girl? You got crudies.
I don't crudies?
Know, crudies?
Crudes.
Croutons.
Crudes, too.
What is up with croutons? Like, who invented croutons?
Croutons are awesome.
Yeah.
I'm not saying they're not awesome. Yeah. I just want to know who was
I
like,
feel like it's some
bread.
Italian.
Make the bread hard. Put it in lettuce.
You mean toasted bread?
Like Italian?
It's
I bet Italians
toasted
made...
bread.
I mean, just
yeah.
Like,
but why?
Think
it's
stale?
Just like a, it's,
but,
a, it's toast
no,
in
I didn't
a cube
think it was
form.
Stale.
Or not even cube. That's a,
that's not the point. Why'd they decide to put it in a salad? Why not just
because
eat it
they're
as
tasty.
It is?
Because
it's crunchy bits.
They're
that's
awesome.
A,
yeah, just eat it.
Because
that's
they
toast.
Like
the adding something crunchy to something that's missing that texture is a thing that's been around for thousands of years. It's not too hard to come up with.
I was gonna say, have you ever had like
not
a,
asking you about whether it's hard to come.
Have you ever had
how
a
did
salad?
They spill the chocolate chips in the regular cookie dough. How can that happen?
I just want to know where it started.
Oh, this is awkward. This happened to me once.
You want to go into a little bit more detail?
I thought oh, just like 20 minutes ago when I did that backflip.
I don't think there. What? I don't think there's a. Okay.
What is happening again?
So
I don't
like,
remember.
He took a photo. It looks like he's being like caught with like a woman who's pants down, like literally. With
yeah,
pants
he literally
down.
Got
yeah,
caught
like,
with his pants
what was
down.
The,
got him.
What was the context?
Because like, what do you mean? Oh,
so,
he was changing to doing the new suit because he
so
didn't want Spider-Man
he knows
to be
that. I keep wanting to call him Tom or Toby. When Peter, when he knows that Peter likes MJ. I need to stop calling them Macri names. He knows that Peter likes MJ.
Yeah.
But he also likes MJ, and he thinks, oh, if this guy's gonna be sleeping with European women, he's not good enough for her, so I'm gonna tell her. Yeah. That's what his idea is.
See, but he took a picture.
And he took a picture of it.
It is weird.
Because
and
he
I
wanted.
Think it should be reflected as that being wrong.
I'm pretty
well,
sure
it is very
it?
Wrong, but
it's
like.
It's very wrong, and everyone else is gonna notice.
Actually, I'm pretty sure that's what happens later.
Yeah,
what?
It is. Yeah.
What?
He says something about it, and they're like, why were you taking a picture of him in the bathroom or something like that?
Yeah, you guys are very smart. It's exactly what happens.
You know what else is very
he's a
wrong?
Simp.
Doing declaring a missile strike on your friend, which you're also.
No, that's fine as long as you stop it.
I sure.
I mean, even if you stop it like halfway through, like
missile, no.
Oh my goodness, that is. Burning up.
How does no one see it, by the way?
No one sees like a yeah.
That is insane. I love it though.
Oh my goodness.
And then the drones are coming in.
Wait. Oh, so he
dude called a drone strike.
I forgot that. Oh, he like punches him. Oh yeah, he slaps him.
I love this movie so much. It's so good.
This movie is really good.
Yeah. I'm so excited for Homesick. I hope they don't take it too serious because it will ruin it.
Wasn't there like a screenshot of Homesick where it was like it was kind of like it had like a more darker tone.
Oh, the trailer is really dark.
Yeah, it was kind of like, you know, in like Cars 3 when they had like the shot of like
Lightning McQueen
just
like
getting
up.
Wrecked.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Literally he wrecked.
Yeah, he
he's
wrecked.
Dead.
Yeah. He's not dead. Owen Wilson forever.
It wasn't a question about whether Owen Wilson is dead.
He died with the character.
If you die in Cause, you die in
that
real life.
That is all I live for anymore!
I've been playing this role for so long that it's become who I am.
Wow, I'm Lightning McQueen, wow.
I am Speed.
Sorry guys, that's just my identity now.
He gets one of those little like play mats with like a road on it, and he gets a little Lightning McQueen toy car, and he's like, wow,
I heard the Peter Griffin.
Wow.
Hey Lois.
Remember like when we
Peter.
I think it was
homie.
Oh homie. Do you guys remember? I forgot what movies it was, but we did I did a thing where it was like Peter Griffin singing the Breath of the Wild theme.
And oh, it was yes.
Like, yes.
Yeah, I think you showed me that. Oh, wow.
They are going to the opera.
Do you think they're
going to
see the Phantom of the Opera? Wow.
No, they're seeing,
oh,
yikes.
Oh,
seeing,
no.
What's that famous? Don Giovanni, that's it.
Oh, my gosh.
Flash is such
a
snob. I've
never
it.
Actually seen an opera.
He's not a snob.
You never
he's
seen
just
an opera?
A narcissist.
Is the Phantom of the Opera an opera?
That's technically a musical.
That's musical theater.
Then
it's
I've never
real.
Seen an opera.
The things they
an
sing is not real opera.
An opera, okay. There's like, an opera is usually...
It's gotta be in Latin and stuff.
Well, most operas are either in Italian, German, or French.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know any of those languages.
And not Latin? Am I wrong in that?
Well,
not
I bet there is, like, at least...
Tries to sing opera, accidentally summons demons. Here in the city...
I don't think. What?
Oh, and like a bunch of like. It summons the actual drink and tomato sauce rains from the sky. That
thing's going to be here. Oh. Samuel Jackson.
You know what's weird?
Did you know, guys? Did I tell you?
Goodness, he's so excited. Yeah? Continue.
Samuel L. Jackson is currently the highest grossing actor of all time. He beat out The Rock.
What's
the
plan? Really?
Yes.
I don't think... See, here's the thing.
These Marvel movies made his pockets deep.
Here's the thing about The Rock. I don't really like him as an actor.
I don't know. I really like that. Can you smell what The Rock is cooking? It's classic.
I like The Rock.
You know what?
He is a decent actor. He has some good range. And I kind of really like his personality offset as well.
He seems like...
I like the chemistry with Kevin Hart.
Oh, yeah.
He seems like one of those guys that, like, would, like, you know, like, if you saw him in real life, he'd go, like, oh, yeah, and he, like, he put his arm around and take a photo, you know?
physical type.
He yeah. seems like he
he's
seems
a big
like
guy, but he seems like a pretty gentle guy, so I don't
he
know.
Seems he like seems like a pretty nice guy.
I watched
that's what
a
he want,
video
that's
about him and his story.
Oh, yeah, his story?
Yeah, about how he kind of, when he was younger, he used to live in poverty.
Oh,
yeah. And so he spent a large amount of his life trying to be successful, and he realized that it affected his personality. And he learned, while getting into Hollywood, about how he wanted to be himself and not the Hollywood image. And so he spent a lot of time working on his identity and going through some stuff. And he comes out on the other end with a really inspiring story. So he's a really cool guy, I'd say.
Yeah. I was once a boulder, but then I became a rock.
How you feeling?
That's the smaller version of him. That's like child rock.
Wait, if you start as a boulder and become a rock, are you suggesting that he's like Benjamin Button or something?
Oh yeah, he bore, yeah.
My mama used to call me Pebble.
Pebble. Oh, that's it. Yeah, Pebble.
Fruity Pebbles.
Boulders.
Cocoa Pebbles.
Wait, yeah, Pebbles from Fred the Flintstone.
Yeah.
Fred the Flintstone.
You guys, Johnson.
Dwayne the Flintstone Johnson. You think he got buffed by eating a lot of Flintstone
Cheerios?
Gummies?
Oh yeah, obviously. Oh, yeah, definitely. Those things are really good for you.
Yeah.
They don't give you diabetes at all.
I think, okay. I think...
You think that was a joke, man?
Man, you're in the real world, man. Do you think that was a joke, man? It's not a joke, man.
I don't have
I'm
to
serious,
work out.
Man.
I just gotta down some Fred Flintstone gummies and then got it all together.
Fred Flintstones are gonna kill you, man.
I wish
they're gonna brainwash you, man.
I wish like
it's
some...
a conspiracy by the government with the Flintstone gummies, man.
I wish some people like who like some Marvel actors and some actors who like are ripped and stuff like I really like that about them. But
you're
like,
gonna ask for a calendar, aren't you?
No, I really want them to admit to like at least some. I want them to admit to the steroids.
Oh no!
Ben is over here like saying, there is no way you have any accomplishment in actually getting fit.
My gosh,
and
Ben.
Muscly.
Well, no, so like
you did steroids.
There'll be like videos of like, have you heard like what it takes to become like a Marvel, like,
yeah, a lot.
Like there'll be
takes
like
a lot of
it
work.
Was, like,
it
takes a lot, and
it was
do
like
the work.
Brie Larson was like, oh yeah, we gotta like she shows like all the exercise like that she did for like Captain
yes.
Marvel and stuff. I'm like,
it's
wow.
insane,
but
they,
like
these people really do it.
They really do, but like I know some of them I just wish they would just say, you know.
I thought you were going to ask for a swimsuit calendar.
No.
I was a little disappointed with what you actually had
I mean,
to say.
If you can come out with both at the same time, that's good.
All right.
Honestly, I would have just read that you had said you wanted a swimsuit calendar.
I want a swimsuit edition.
Go for the Speedos. You know, the Flash. Speedos. Marvel characters, you get it?
That's total. That's
the Flash is DC.
That's the director's pitch.
Yeah, that's what Zack Snyder said.
You know, there's like the Flash, and then there's the Speedo, and then
the Speedo,
and then we just got straight up Thong.
The Thong. The Thong sounds like Flash's like it's like the Flush. Like Flash's like really weird cousin.
The Flourish.
The Flourish.
Beat the rush. You gotta rush out.
Sorry, I need a moment.
He needs a moment to.
I need a moment to let that sink into me.
What, the Flush or.
Alright, let's talk about what's going on here. This is another really
so
good
basically,
character scene.
They do the opera. They do the opera. They are the opera.
They repeat the thing that Tobey Maguire went through.
You guys
I mean,
are
Peter
all
Parker.
The opera.
The Tobey Maguire Spider-Man's explore the same
the
issue.
Opera. We are
oh, yeah.
all the opera.
He wants to be
Every
there for MJ, but he can't because he has responsibility. One of the most popular themes of Spider-Man that they introduce within a lot of other new things, which I like.
Also, the themes that like him and Mysterio talk about are like because he's like telling him like, yeah, I just want to like really like I just want to ask this girl out, and he's like, you know, I understand like wanting to be a normal kid because like it's weird how like some people will go, man, I wish I was like Spider-Man. I wish I had these powers, but then like in here, he doesn't really want them. Like he just wants to be normal.
Like
kind of funny.
Yeah.
You kind of always want what you can't have.
Yeah.
Once you have it, you kind of realize it's not what you wanted at all.
Like, when I want a lightsaber and I get a lightsaber, I go, wait a minute, there's no one to duel
this brought no fulfillment to my life.
Dude, I could get a lightsaber and then we could duel.
But, like, what about if I'm the only human on the planet that gets one wish from a genie in the bottle?
And you ask for a lightsaber.
And I ask for one lightsaber.
Why not ask for two?
Genie, it's a bottle? Genies don't come in bottles.
You don't know that.
Ask for two.
Yeah! I have to get one blue, one red so I can fight my enemy. Wait.
There is a blue one.
It was my friend. It was also my enemy. It was my friend.
I also want a million.
So you know how like pickles. So you know how like the genie in Aladdin is like, you know, like it's set in the Middle East and stuff, so it comes in a like lamp, right? What about like in every part of the world, every continent, there is like a different item that a genie spawned in?
Mm-hmm.
So like it was like on the on
you go
like
to Germany, you rub like a
it's like a beer, a beer stein, and then just like a genie pops out, and goes, "Oh hello,
what do you want?
What do you want? Three wishes,
eins wish, zwei wish, drei wish. What do you want?
I cannot make anyone die or fall in love."
Rule number 1, no love. Rule number 5, no kill.
One rule only, no death, no fall in love.
That's two rules, but we count it as one. I make you rich though.
Stop. I make you very rich. You have all the beer you ever wanted!
Guys, I'm crying.
You can get all the breakfast you
all
want!
All the breakfast, all the pretzels!
All the schnitzel!
Oh my gosh.
All the
pretzels with cheese?
All the beer gardens you ever wanted, it's right here! Just ask me for it, I will give it to you!
That has to be the best thing ever.
Do you want a schnitzel?
You got the bun fish.
I am absolutely crying. Okay.
I'm quite dry. I can give you all those wishes.
Before he says anything, the person tries to ask for someone to die, and they're like, NINE! No kill!
No kill! No death!
Nine.
No kill!
No death! No kill! NINE! Not allowed!
German genie.
I want it to be Will Smith still playing that character.
Would the genie be like a different color? Would he not be blue? Would he be like purple or something? And just like, hello!
Hang on. Okay, let's assume that the name wouldn't be Aladdin. What would the German version be?
If not Aladdin?
Yeah.
Adolf.
What about like?
Well, it's a German name that begins with the letter A.
Yes.
Oh, yeah,
it's okay.
That is okay.
Yeah.
Amsterdam. That's not a German name, but it starts with A.
That's a Denver name.
Amsterdam is a place, though. That's a
so?
Denver name?
There are people named.
It's Denvish.
Danish? It's a Denver Danish name.
Denvish.
I'll tell you what, you get three wishes when you rub my cowboy boots. You get three wishes.
Is that the Texas, is that the North America one? Three wishes.
I'll tell you what, Frida.
Consume
problem.
Prince Adolfo. Deutschland.
Pretzel cheese.
Pretzel cheese. Beer gardens everywhere. What you want?
So,
all the friends are named Svan.
Svan!
Top-tier bit we're doing here.
Oh my goodness. This is like, I think this is the best bit we've, like, oh I think I've God. Ever, like, been a part of.
That, I feel like that just made it the best moment of all time. Like, I've never...
I'm dying.
Oh my gosh. Oh, yay, St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, Heidi Tidy, you want three wishes, eh?
Stop. It's funny, but I can't handle it. I might actually die.
Oh, I'm so hurt, for real.
Oh, man. No, the fire shaved all my beard off. It burned my beard. Oh, I'm just as bald as a whistle now.
Totally
bald as a whistle?
Don't ask. My analogies are from the other universe, man.
Do you want me to connect you to my makeup artist?
Oh man, stroke my beard, man.
So it's over?
My makeup artist likes to do that. But not the last. Every day of shooting.
Yeah. So did he actually like get hurt? Is that the idea?
I don't
like.
Well, he's not. He. This is
or is it like
fake.
Projected onto him? Or is it? Oh, it's not actually him. That's right.
It's all fake. So like,
he's
these
not
are just
actually
projections.
In the suit right now.
My thing is, so if they're all projections. Oh, so he himself is a sorry. I'm
yes,
confused.
They're all okay. Things that you can touch and feel.
Yeah,
yeah, because it can do actual damage. So
because
it's not like they'll like touch him and they'll be like, oh, it went through
yeah.
him.
Yeah, it's not like the doctor from.
That is amazing technology. Why didn't Stark use that?
Oh yeah, to like just.
You can project an entire military.
Oh yeah,
and you made it into a self therapy.
Well, that's
machine.
Like
that is genuinely like.
Well, because I'm telling, it's like the last movie in this series. It's like Michael Keaton was trying to just be an ordinary man, but like Stark, he could have used this technology for more
than
just.
Is Stark the true villain of this? That's an incredibly large oversight.
That's like the most like favorite like directors or writers thing to do is like make the
bad. And that car is in the same angle.
Oh yeah,
to be in the background. Sorry.
You wanna buy this car?
I know, right? They know what they're doing.
You just saw it in
Spiderman
Samuel
Jackson owned one,
in the
so
middle
I
of an
one
awesome
too.
Fight, and now you want to buy it. Yeah.
If he didn't have like the things on, he just looks like a really weird robber.
The car comes with Tom Holland.
I was just sitting
and
on lemonade.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Gyllenhaal.
Wait, bam. That's not Jake Gyllenhaal, is it?
Who is Jake Gyllenhaal?
Yeah, that's Jake Gyllenhaal.
Yeah, that's Jake Gyllenhaal.
Yeah.
Oh, it's him.
Yeah. I need to watch Nightcrawler.
He looks like...
I thought you were going to say Brokeback Mountain, and I was like, I don't want to watch that.
Isn't that Heath Ledger?
Mysterio
though?
Looks
a
lot,
Heath Ledger and Jake Gyllenhaal.
Both of them.
Mr. Stark.
Mysterio looks a lot like this pastor who was at a summer camp I went to a while ago.
He has a glowing suit.
Like,
he wears
just,
green, wears
just,
a fishbowl.
Just put him into that, like, that
smoke everywhere.
That lumberjack red plaid
oh,
and
yeah.
skinny jeans, and then
oh,
you got
I used
you got
to
that
have
pastor.
Red plaid.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
I want to go back my baby cousin Cole has a shirt like that. And it is the best. With the girl who I really like and tell her how I feel. But yeah,
amongst many things I was called in middle school, lumberjack was one of them.
Oh, really?
Yes, along with dill pickle.
Oh, was it hurtful?
No, actually.
You're okay? Okay.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay. That's good.
Where'd you come from, lady? What?
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from?
No, no, no.
Night Night Joe? What?
Cop Nigel, I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cop Nigel?
My PE class in elementary school had us dance to that.
I do remember the square
dancing.
You're
just like doing backflips and everything.
No, we had to do like square dancing.
Oh, yeah.
It's weird.
Yeah, there was a dance, like, yeah, a square dancing unit in PE at my middle school. Did you go to the F school?
The
the F.
No, he didn't go to the F school.
Yeah, I did not go to the F school.
I did not go to the F school.
It was weird because during that square dancing unit, I was the only one who got to dance with a girl because there was only one girl in our class. I was not ready for something like this. Why would he give it to you? Because maybe he didn't trust me to have Edith. He just trusted me to pick. And I remember being like, yes,
I'm not throwing away my shot.
This is my chance. This is my chance. And I was like the best dancer.
If you had one shot,
one opportunity.
I like joked to her about how awkward it is, and she joked to me about how awkward it is, and I was like, oh, you joked with me.
And then you guys
about how awkward it is. And we joked about the same thing. No.
And then you guys.
This means love.
And then you guys held hands one day, and then didn't talk to each other again.
I like hands on the shoulder. You know that thing.
Hands on the
That's
shoulder.
What square dancing
you know
is,
that
baby.
Thing. You know
never
what
done
it
square
is,
dance,
hands
so just
on the
imagine,
shoulder.
Like, both people on the shoulder just moving their hips back and forth. Because I've never seen it before.
But so. What ain't got you? I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where? Only the shoulders. Don't go anywhere below.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, don't go. Wait.
Don't go anywhere.
Yeah, syllables.
The scansion's broken.
Yeah,
dang
syllables
it.
Are.
I could never be a freestyle and rapist. Sorry.
That's not what they're called.
Honestly, in terms of like messing up a word, I used to think Norwegians came from a country called Norwegia.
Oh, that's yeah, but that's like
I don't know how many Freudian slips I've made.
Oh boy. That's like one of my favorite. I don't know why, but Freudian slip just sounds like funny to me.
It's your favorite mistake.
It's like
you do it quite a bit too.
Oh
so.
Yeah.
I don't know if Dale has any.
But I don't even know what it means.
Okay, so
it's when you combine like you probably explain it better.
So yeah, it's like I don't really cuz it's like when you like mistake.
It's like when you forget how to explain a word to someone.
I'm trying to think how to explain this cuz I know exactly
it's
like
when you like combine two words and say them individually. Like you replace letters with the letters of the other word.
Yeah.
Makes sense?
See, that no. So hard.
It's essentially like you
can
do
you give me an example?
Let me think.
It's gonna try.
I don't know one off the top of my head. It's kind of a tricky thing.
I'm just gonna look
it's essentially it's kind of like a stutter. Okay, but it's in the stutter. Connected to our system. It's kinda like that.
I am so confused right now.
It's a slippage. Of the tongue. Okay, tongue. That is classified as Freudian. To the man who brought us all together. You know
oh, yeah.
Sigmund Freud?
Yes. Well,
oh yes, I know Sigmund Freud.
Well, cause it's just basically like an error in speech or memory.
Yeah. It's a type of stutter.
I think Freudian slip can mean like another thing though. A revolutionary breakthrough. I think it means like something you have to do with actually like what Freud believed.
Oh, it's
yeah.
Like when you,
so.
When you accidentally express that you have the same beliefs as Freud?
Well, no, like, it's,
whoops!
It's like when. Okay, I need to find an example.
Almost lost my cool. My life's work. Bark.
I told him it was a mistake that my technology could change. Yeah, that is a huge injustice to that technology. If it can actually destroy things, like, you've got a weapon, you've got a form of entertainment. Because that's unstable. Full tactile kinesthetic VR that you've just created.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
Gaming, education, you don't need to hire teachers
well,
anymore.
Now it's like, it's AR
oh.
too. Like, it's
augmented
reality.
I didn't realize that
reality.
Was the same dude.
Yeah, it's the same dude.
I love that scene. Was
brilliant. Built it in a cave with a box of scraps.
So an example of Freudian slip is so like when a child accidentally calls their teacher mom is because like they're spending most of their like transitioning from spending most of their day from like with their mother to
really
their teacher.
I have awkwardly done that.
Yeah, because you can because like oh
so
I'm spending so like summer you spend
yeah.
like all day family
yeah.
brother sister whatever.
I guess so because I've called my dad mom before.
And then like yeah so you spend
it happens.
You
it
spend
does.
Too much. Because
my
mom
was a stay-at-home mom and my dad went to work.
Yeah.
My
so,
grandma
like,
sometimes calls
me
by my father's name.
Oh, the one that was... I've done that before. And it hurts my heart to this day.
What?
I was talking to my dad. Like, I used to work with my grandpa on rental properties. And I was talking to my dad about... no when I was working with my grandpa, and I called my grandpa dad to my dad. Well, and like the disappointment in his face of, oh, you're spending a lot of time with him, aren't you? And I was like, no, it's because I'm talking to you. And so I was thinking of you. No, it wasn't because of that. It hurts my heart to this day. So yes, I have done the Freudian slip before. Oh, yeah.
Or I guess another example would be like, so say you're dating someone and then you broke up with them and then you accidentally like
call them all the wrong name.
That's a Freudian slip, is when you call your current partner or whatever your ex's name.
Ouch. That's gotta hurt.
Ouch.
That's an Avengers level threat.
Yeah, I was gonna say that is an Avengers level threat.
Yikes, yeah, Freudian slip. The biggest villain of all time.
I feel like in like some
I blame the election on the Freudian slip. Biden slipped on me, and I'm Freud.
He's claiming to be he's claiming to be an Australian.
That was my dad. I'm Sigmund Freud Jr. The end justifies the means. That's what Sigmund Freud said.
I'm just kidding. So I was gonna say, so wait a minute, So Donald Trump has
Biden's dad was Macchiato Valley.
It's Machiavelli combined with macchiatos.
Yeah. Macchiato.
Mochavelli?
Mochavelli. Locomotion belly.
Locomotion. Oh yes! Courageous moment.
Where were you?
Locomocaccino.
I got lost. We were worried about you. You're back.
Yeah.
So much for Paris.
They're playing Among Us.
I was gonna say they're playing Among Us up there.
Night.
Night.
It's fun.
Yeah.
It's fun times.
You look nice.
102. Yeah, I was an electrical.
That face he just made.
Oh, he's gonna not.
Red is an Aquarius.
That'd be funny if he just like plowed through, just like accidentally shoulder charged the door. And he just fell right through.
Well, he was going for the knock.
Yeah,
honestly, well, like he was
like his shoulder was like ready to go.
Knocked her in the head.
Yeah. Bonk.
Are you in there, McFly?
McFly, hello.
McFly, are you in there? Zendaya, what's your last name?
What is it?
Tell me! Zendaya, boyfriend is who?
Dude, I'm freaking bummed. Oh,
that's good.
That's like, that gives me like so much nostalgia of just playing it like Minecraft on my iPad. Because that's a Steve like hurt noise when he's like drowning. Just
I've got it on my phone. I play it every once in a while.
Yeah.
People on this bridge, they would like put them in a basket and they would.
Gosh, these actors are so good. Like, look what they're doing with their hands.
Sorry.
They're really displaying the awkwardness.
It's amazing that they're feeling. Communicate with just hand movements and like the way they hold their shoulders. Like you can tell they're very tense and like she darts her eyes a lot. Particularly in his direction and
they're,
stuff.
Yeah, they're, like, they're both, like, really shy, which is
they're
kinda...
both really good actors.
They are. Like, that's when...
like, their body language is so good. Look at that.
MJ,
I just really like when, there'll be sometimes when I'm watching something and I'll get into, like, a mindset where you're just, like, you don't see them as, like, Zendaya or Tom Holland, where you see them as the actual characters.
Yep.
Instead of like just like, oh, these people that are like real life people, but like they're like these personalities and stuff.
Yeah, that's kind of something like if you study film at all, it kind of ruins a certain aspect. Like it's harder for me to get into a movie because I'm just looking at it as an industry. I do really like, I know something's really good when it breaks me out of that mode and I just get enveloped. Like Inception did that to me when I first watched it.
Oh yeah.
So I do love it when that happens, but when you study the industry, you do kind of slip into this analytical mindset instead of an enjoyment of it.
There was, there was this website I went to once that was like, because I wanted to see like what like some people's like worst actors and actresses of all time were, and like a weird point that they brought up was like, Owen Wilson was like the 10th worst actor ever because he can't be anything but Owen Wilson. Which is kind of a weird standpoint where
Nick Cage on there?
Oh yeah, I think he wasn't number one. Tommy Wiseau was number one.
What
you have against Nicolas Cage. He's a great actor. He's the best of the best. Better than Samuel Jackson.
I think...
only person who passes Nicolas Cage is Shia LaBeouf, I tell you that.
Who are you saying this as?
I was going to say, what is your,
no
your
one.
Voice?
Wait, is this you?
Dale?
Oh, Dale? Is this Dale or is it's this real his persona?
Oh my gosh. Yeah, well, Nick Cage extremely irritates me because he is the example of a flat actor who cannot get an ounce of life into a performance.
I'm going to steal the Declaration of Independence.
I like how in National Treasure, like,
not the beast.
Nick Cage is supposed to be like the, he's supposed to be the main dude, but like Sean Bean does better acting than he does in it, which is kind of funny. Because I'm just like, Sean Bean, great actor. Nick Cage, great potato.
I'm sorry, it's true. Like, the guy doesn't know how to add these details that they do. He just projects his same flat tone.
Oh, yeah. He's just, like, that's why it, like, really takes you out of it, is when you go, like, when he goes, oh, it's just Nick Cage projecting himself onto this character that doesn't really...
He's tone deaf, flat, and incapable of adding the details that we see in these actors.
Like, yeah.
That was also one of the things that I kind of hated about being in theater. Like, I like theater, but I love cinema.
Yeah.
Just because you can add all these tiny, subtle details. The camera's close enough, the audio's close enough. You can be so specific. But with theater, you have to be really big, you have to project, you gotta reach the back row, all those things. Especially at our school, where they don't actually let you wear mics for like 3 out of 4 of the shows. So... you're just shouting like this, whatever you're saying, and it ruins the performance.
There was one show that I went to where I was like, man, like, this just seems kind of cringy. Like,
it's over the top. It's large movements. That's what they teach you in theater. And that's the way you successfully do an audition. You don't get an audition by doing good acting. Mm-hmm. You get an audition... by being able to express big movements and your voice. If you talk loudly, you are 10 times more likely to successfully audition for something. I told somebody that, and they went all out being really loud. They got one of the lead roles, even though they had never acted before. And I didn't get one. Because I hate theater. Not hate, sorry.
You don't, yeah.
Sorry, I
mean, I
don't hate theater.
That's why I'm just, like... I never really got into it because I was just, I don't know. I didn't really, I just thought it was kind of like, there's like really good performances and there's like really cringy performances. And I guess it's just how you look at it can be cringy or like, I bet even to some people this movie could be
like
cringy.
You put theater actors in a movie and it automatically gets cringy. Every theater actor will overact in a movie unless you tell them to do differently.
Yeah.
Like working with Caitlin and Patience on Footsteps. They're theater actresses. Really amazing theater actresses, and they moved over to this medium really well. As soon as I told them, guys, I want you to eliminate projection from the equation, and I want you to focus on the subtleties, because you don't have to reach the front row, let alone the back row.
Yeah.
Of course.
And that difference is enormous in the progression from theater to cinema. And some people really like theater just because of the rush of it being live, the set design, the way like the costumes work.
Yeah.
Like it's very exciting.
Yeah, I like
even
it.
If you have a small role in it.
There's like some, I guess, I don't know if you call them critics, but there's like some people that are just like theater actors and like people who, I guess, another set of like theater actors, like people who are in musicals actually do work, when like some people say like film actors don't do any, because like they'll be like line and stuff like that, when like in theater and musicals you can't do that at all. And so it's just, you just have to go with it.
It's unprofessional to not be memorized for a cinematic thing. I will say that it's extremely frustrating and it wastes a lot of time.
Well, there's even things with like I guess Brendan Fraser is one of them, where like they'll be in like Island of Dr. Moreau. He would just like, he's like, he was, that was like when he was old and stuff, and he'd be like,
I don't think Brendan Fraser was in that.
After what? I had to kill Peter Parker, I thought he was Dr. Moreau. I hope you
remember that his blood. The one with Val Kilmer?
Yeah. Or no, that's not Val Kilmer. There's something else where, like, there's just, like, not horror stories, but, like, stories about, like, how he'd have, like, some people's, like, lines so he could just read them out. Like, there'd be people behind with, like, lines and boards and stuff so you could just read it.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I'm just like, oh, man.
I do have to say, though, like,
I love
as an actor myself, the biggest spots that I've struggled in is over memorization, which just means that I've focused so much on the specific list of things. Oh gosh, specific list of things that I need to do that it becomes rigid.
Oh, yeah.
And I tell actors that you do not want to overthink a role. You have to make it part of it you in order for it to look right, instead of memorizing a bunch of cues and specific details and lines. Your lines become too rigid.
I had to take you out of it, but this is also like what you're talking about, like how she'll like barely just like move her head over and over, and she's just like as he's like changing and stuff.
So I had to look up a parent's guide to this movie in order to convince my parents to be able to watch it.
Well, there's no edited part. Like,
oh no, yeah, it's no fine to watch, but I liked how the review stated. Like a long and Peter undresses, and MJ moves and turns around, even though she clearly wants to see what's going on. And I'm like, I think you might be reading into that.
That's really harsh. That's like, really harsh.
They really like to, if you state details from movies like that out of context, it makes movies sound really dirty.
Yeah.
It really does.
That's why, like, sometimes, like, I think, like, they'll misquote, like, or they'll, like, misguide, like, some parents and that kind of stuff.
It's true.
It's also, like, the journalism aspect of it is, like, she, like what you're saying, she really wants to know what's going on in her mind. Like, you don't know what's in her mind during this.
Well, they were just stating the fact that, like, she starts to turn around and peak.
Yeah, but it's like, it's like the journalism thing is like, oh, I'm doing fine, as his brow, like, sweated and he was really tense and his hand shook.
That's just the idea of, like, if you take raw facts and rephrase them, you change the meaning of the facts.
Yeah, it's just distorting, like, what the actual, like, the actual truth of the whole situation is.
Yeah, that's just the problem with modern day journalism, especially with sensationalism mixed in.
Yeah, look, we're in Germany, we're in Deutschland.
Stop.
I really want to do more
schnitzels.
I really want to do
the problem is, the more you do, the more I have to leave in, and I need other stuff to be in this video.
I think I'm going to do it on my own time, just, like, coming up with a whole, like, lyric set to,
They don't even call him the German genie. His name is just casually Hans.
Hans! his name, yeah. Or, like, Lars.
Lars?
Like, you know Metallica's drummer, Lars?
Yeah, Lars Ulrich?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think that's how you pronounce it.
Lars Ulrich. Looks like it's pronounced Ulrich, but it's just Ulrich.
Yeah.
What you're seeing on screen is all a projection.
Fake news.
By Jake Gyllenhaal. I mean, yeah, Jake Gyllenhaal.
By Jake Gyllenhaal.
I'll allow it.
All of it.
What's that from?
It's like a court. It's like a judge thing where he's
it's
like,
the judge,
oh, wow.
Yes, from some movie.
Well, it's just like, it could be, it's like even from like, I bet like a lot, like several Law and Order episodes where it's just like, oh, I'll allow it.
I've been watching the Game Grumps series Phoenix Wright lately.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I like
not
that
from
game.
That. It's a cool game. The judge is a total pushover, though. Like, the judge sucks.
Dude,
he really sucks.
I keep playing it. Need to be smart.
Yeah. Apparently, Game Grumps only played Ace Attorney, and I was extremely disappointed because I've already almost finished all 60 of their episodes on it in like 2 weeks.
Do you want to play the other two?
Play the other two?
Yeah.
Ourselves?
Yeah. Whoa. I mean, there's like,
how much do they cost?
Oh, I have it.
No, Phoenix. I mean, you.
Oh yeah, when you're talking about how.
I mean, like, because there's like Phoenix Wright, like Ace Attorney, and then there's like two more after that.
Yeah,
we can play it. I have them, all three of them. But
not what? Real? Yeah, I would love to. Do you have them for Switch?
Yeah.
I tried to help you walk away.
Okay. Yes. I'm gonna take that as a. We gotta do this.
The other series I've been watching of theirs is called Danganronpa.
I've really been binging Super Mario 64.
It's like Phoenix Wright, but a lot more.
How?
I don't know how I would put it. A lot more comedic, absurd, cartoonish.
What's going on?
Which, I know this isn't real. And also less, it's not written very well, but the plot moves in a very interesting way. Yikes! Oh! My question is, this is a computer simulation, but who designed this? Like, it takes forever to design things like this.
Well, I mean, this is, so, like, we don't know, like, all the advancements in, like, computer technology. This is, like...
Yeah, but that's, what, Unreal Engine 5 is going to be able to do this? Like, who spent hours, like, hundreds of hours on this simulation to play for Peter? That's my thought when I watched this.
Yes.
It can't be creating itself. That's way too detailed for 2023, whatever.
I keep forgetting to mention this, but like something I didn't realize about Samuel Jackson. I didn't realize he was the most or top grossing actor of all time. But I didn't realize he hasn't won an Oscar, like for anything.
Yeah. His shot was Pulp Fiction for sure.
Yeah.
You are just a
what?
That's one of the lines from the movie.
Oh.
Did you say...
No.
You swore.
I didn't.
I mean, he purposely didn't say that part. We have video footage, Dale. Well, not video, I guess audio footage.
Yes, the peck statue. Look at it.
The peck statue.
Look at those.
It's like Sandman.
Those are not what it actually looks like on him.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, I pulled... yes.
I pulled a crane down.
Unreal Engine 6. The Fist of Glory.
If all of it's...
Yeah, all of this
computer generated, then, like, none of this would actually hurt him. Would it?
Well, no. The idea is it stimulates actual physics.
Yeah, so, like, the drones can project, like, actual matter, like, into his brain and, like, so, like, it'll affect.
Oh, look. Black Widow spiders.
Cool.
So, like, that's why...
Oh, I can't wait till I live in California, because then I'll have to deal with possible Black Widow infestations. Oh, that's a common thing for that state.
Really?
Yeah.
Maybe you shouldn't live in California.
Well, I mean, how's he gonna go to college?
Do you know how many people in the country die by spiders a year? Now?
Have you ever...
Like, probably, like, 2,000?
Moving Four? To Australia?
Four!
So,
why Australia? Australia, that's even, like, more!
Yeah, it can actually rain spiders in Australia. That's not a joke. There has been some situations where certain storm patterns are light enough to pick up a spider and drop it, and there's so many spiders. Even in the U.S., there's so many spiders that it's easy to collect a huge amount of them and let it drop. And spiders, they don't die from falling, because they can survive falling at their terminal velocity, so as they land on you, they are alive.
What?
Australia is cool, question mark?
Well, the thing about it is spiders, all you have to do is dribble some water on them and they'll drown. So they're probably dead, actually.
Australia's death trap, I'm convinced.
So it's raining.
They didn't fall and go splat, they drowned.
Yeah.
Okay. So yes, Ben, if you drop a spider into a lake, it's gonna drown.
Oh my goodness, that is a callback to several... episodes ago.
And theoretically, if you got a strong enough storm, you could pick up sharks.
I love Sharknado, but
heck
I
yeah.
hate it at the same time.
I love the
I
thing.
I have the same feelings about Sharknado that I do for Final
I think
Destination.
It's a trailer. I hate Final Destination. There's like I think it was a trailer for one of the Sharknado movies where a guy has like a running chainsaw, jumps into the mouth of a shark, and cuts his way through the other end and falls out in a crazy slow motion shot.
Mm-hmm.
It's so good.
So why do you hate Final Destination?
It has a lot of shock value and not a lot of substance.
Like Saw,
yes.
Fair.
I don't like movies that show shock value without backing it up, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
That's my opinion for horror movies in general. You can show the guts if you want to, but you gotta have some other element of horror to go with it if you want it to be effective.
This is a good
scene. Wait, where are we?
This is the Netherlands.
They said they found you on crunches.
That's what's weird about the Netherlands. Their flag is like red, white, and blue, but they mostly just dress up in orange for like sports and stuff.
I don't know who these dudes are, but they seem like totally cool guys.
Yeah, I want to hang out with them in prison.
They seem like someone like you'd meet.
I feel like they're probably here for something stupid, like partying too hard. You're just like, they got a little bit too crazy at
it's
the party,
like,
and now they're in jail.
It's like the judge is like, what is...
Oh, don't worry. Aggravated assault.
It's just like, so you know in courtrooms when they have
I'm
to...
I'm facing 30 to life.
Just kidding!
You know in like...
Just kidding, they're all dead.
My goodness. You know, in like courtrooms when you have to announce like what you did.
He's wearing the mask.
It's like what did you do? It's like I partied too hard.
Like how I love this.
Okay. He just called him.
Oh my goodness.
We've like it here. Oh wait, they're not Germans anymore. They're Dutch.
You like it here.
Good job.
We want to stay.
What is that Dutch accent?
Dutch accent. Oh hey man, can I borrow your phone? I'm Dutch.
Wait, hang on. Wait. We might have one real quick.
That looks like old what's his name? The guy from Gladiator.
Russell Crowe?
Yeah. Yeah, old Russell Crowe.
Yeah, Russell Crowe. We have yet to get a request to watch A Beautiful Mind.
I haven't seen it.
Oh guys.
Where is that cheese back there?
It's so good.
They got cheese back there.
We're talking about a movie, and Ben's just like, is that cheese back there?
It can be really, it's a really depressing movie, but it's also very inspiring.
No problem.
No problem. I guess that's how they sound. That's how old Russell Crowe sounds.
Oh, dude. Look at those nice flower fields. Did you die
inside? Sorry, that was... I don't know what to do. I'm having stomach issues again from my pizza.
What's the deal?
I got like the worst stomach bug like a week ago.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
It was so bad. Do you want to hear about it?
I don't know.
Okay? Yeah, Dale.
Okay.
It was to the point where
give me all the deets.
I hadn't peed for a couple days.
You know what?
Hadn't peed for a couple days.
That's not good.
Do you know why?
Why?
Because it came out another way.
There is another.
There is another. There is another
for your belly button.
Oh no! It was so bad that like it was. No. Just, I just pooped straight water. Like it was clear.
Peter, you got to tell me what the hell's going on here.
Insane, right? And it was like a gallon.
Oh no!
It was like 20 straight minutes of a scream, and I was like, "Do I have dysentery or not?"
It's like those.
And I looked it up, and there was no blood.
I feel like you could, like, some rich guy would buy. It's like I got a whole gallon of poop water here. Anyone want some? It's like a rich guy buys it for like $1 million.
Gamer girl poop water.
Ew. The concept of bathtub water is already kind of weird enough that I don't think we need an even weirder form of that.
Oh my gosh. Dysentery water.
You want to die like several like thousand soldiers did in the Civil War?
When it comes to dysentery water, Bella Delphine, I believe it. I believe anything.
Do you have the wish to die?
Of dysentery?
Introducing the new revolutionary technique, gain dysentery.
You ever played the Oregon Trail?
I did in middle school, yeah. In
I did.
Class.
Yeah, I did it in like 8th grade.
I can't sucked not at get dysentery.
I think everyone sucks at that game. No offense to any pro Oregon Trail players out there.
It's too RNG. I don't know if that's me happy. Do I sound hip with that?
Yeah.
Role-playing game.
That's
death.
You know, playing with an N.
Not random number generator. Role-playing game. RNG.
Role playing.
Oh, he like burped before that.
Game. Everything he did, he was
all over the place. Sorry, I was trying to see if I could one up my second guess was jazz music stops bit, but I couldn't. It's okay though.
Jazz music intensifies.
Dude, jazz music drill.
I haven't seen a meme like that for a long time, but that's still like one of my favorite memes ever.
Your friends are in trouble.
Really?
That and the to be continued meme.
I really like.
Oh, that's from JoJo's Bizarre
Adventure. I really
like
Leo's version of it side by side with the original.
Yeah, dude, I love it.
So good.
Dude, I love.
Hey, Peter, you look a little homesick.
Jesus.
That was such.
That was the to be continued meme. Sorry.
One time we went to, me and Leo went to like a music store before, and he just picked up like, cause he knows Leo, and he picked up a guitar and started playing the theme. So like, and he played the whole thing, like a good like 2 minutes of them, and then he goes.
Spiderman watches my live streams. Oh, like, I'm so excited in the next movie to see what Flash's reaction to the fact that Spider-Man was Peter Parker the whole time.
Flash?
Yeah. Don't you remember?
You know.
Like, he's
like
always
Speedos,
like...
Speedos, the Flash...
No, Flash Thompson. He, says a ton of things about how he really likes Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah.
And then he turns to Peter and is like,
sub nerd.
Nerd.
He says horrible
nerd.
Things
oh, yeah.
to Peter.
Yeah. That's what, there's that one scene in Venice. I was like, wow, that's kind of ironic. Where he's just like, I love Spider-Man. He's like, he encouraged me to be a better person. Sup, nerd.
I like, thank you for censoring it. Good job.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He says something else, but I was like,
Master White. Master White.
Oh, dude, that's an awesome joke. He's like, man, I love Led Zeppelin. It's AC/DC.
Yeah. and most of the kids watching this movie do not get that. Like, the first time I watched it, I did not. I was like, yeah, Led Zeppelin!
I once mixed Back in Black and Highway to Hell together, so it was like, down, no stop signs. Speed limit.
Speed limit.
I can't do a good impression of the head singer, but I love it.
Woo! Yeah.
I like the. I like some like the. I really like some of the moments in like the modern. How I Met Your Mother, Muppets movie, where they go.
Did you just confuse How I Met Your Mother?
No, what's his name? The main dude from How I Met Your Mother is in the main Muppets movie. That's why I confused them.
Oh, I see. What's
his name? I forgot his name.
The old Freudian slip.
Okay.
Technically, that was.
I guess that technically was. Can I be called the king of Freudian slips?
Can I be called King Freud?
Wouldn't it technically be the professor of Freudian slips?
I thought you were about to say the professional and professionals, and I was like, dang it, he did it too. It's just a really good example of a Freudian slip that I've done so many times.
Technically we are part of the professional professionals for
not
that
anymore.
One.
Oh, wait, yeah, you were.
Well,
yeah,
because
sorry.
Not anymore. We deleted those H Calamity videos.
Sorry, I forgot you were in a gaming video. I was saying
did
that...
you say, what do you mean, not anymore? Did you delete something?
Because I thought you were going to say we technically are the professional and professionals because Fanatics is within. Nope, we're within
whatever
our production
is. Oh, incorporated now?
Either one.
We're like getting upgraded. It's Productions Incorporated, Inc. Wait, no, Incorporated is just Inc.
It was
so.
Originally Incorporated, but we're technically a production company. So.
Incorporated sounds like we're like big business. So we're fighting for the little guy.
Give me your money.
It's technically both an Incorporated and a production company.
There we go.
Because it makes money, so it's a business.
Do we make money?
30
cents.
If we were monetized right now, it would be like 30 cents, yes. Pretty insane, right?
I don't think you could do a show like this monetized.
Yeah, you could.
Are you good?
Yeah. I actually, on our best of compilation, I got demonetized and blocked 27 times in a row by 27 different movies. And I disputed every case, and I won every single one.
Wow.
So that video is monetizable as soon as we have a YouTube partnership.
Oh yeah, so you need the YouTube partnership to actually become more.
Yep, I need I need 1,000 subscribers, and I need permission from each production company who owns the movie.
We're 1/10 of the way there. A little bit more than 1/10.
The thing about it is you got to consider that a growth arc is exponential. So we're not 1/10 of the way there. We're halfway.
Wait, what do you mean?
Because exponential doesn't move. In a consistent upward motion moves in an arc.
So you think we're gonna have the one?
As soon as we start growing, we'll start growing faster the longer we've been growing. That's how YouTube works.
I see. Okay. Don't ever call this number. Do you think this German Aladdin bit is gonna get us to the top?
Oh, I'm sure. Oh yeah.
we're gonna take that all the way.
Our new professional and professionals format has been doing well.
Okay, that's good to hear.
And the Cinematic Fanatic podcast has been doing okay.
Yeah.
In fact, some of our podcasts, like the Christmas Chronicles podcast, got more views than highlights.
Yeah, I was looking at that when I watched it. I was like, even like on Christmas when I watched it, it was.
Do you know why that is, though?
Do you think like more people like to have it in like background, or as they're watching it?
It's because one of the tags is full movie, he's just a guy, so people look up Christmas Chronicles full movie,
and
video shows up.
True, we're clicking them.
Well, we're not. We reacted to the full movie.
We didn't. They just have to watch it. That's funny.
Yeah.
Because obviously you can't put full movie in highlights.
Nope, you can't. It is working. I can, though.
I mean, I can
also put Minecraft, Fortnite, Among Us.
I'm gonna go get your friend.
Dude, that's how you make Peter the money. Back
that's how you make the money.
So make the big bucks.
Make your money on the 12-year-olds. Morgs and Logan Paul style.
I think... Open Logan style.
That sucked. I'm so sorry.
Oh my goodness. You're gonna get banned from the internet community now.
For cringe?
Yeah.
Cueing lightning? You have been diagnosed with dead.
Oh man, spooky, spooky, scary ghost.
Spooky cloud! Ah!
Oh, that cloud?
Come on!
Had a face.
We gotta get to the chopper!
Were you like a cross between Arnold and Miss Piggy?
You gotta get to the chopper!
Hermit, get to the chopper! Well!
Hermit! I can't do a Miss Piggy voice.
Oh no, yeah.
Miss Piggy.
I always love that that Yoda is Miss Piggy. Yeah.
Wait, are you serious?
Well, Frank Oz. Kermit.
Frank Oz. Yeah.
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 Okay, let's. That is not how those buses work. Don't you dare tell me.
What? Exploded midair.
Exploded enormously. How much gasoline was in that thing? Into the water.
Okay. Think about it this way: the driver was a part of this whole thing. So they could rig the bus to have exploded that way.
But they have death clouds. Why would they need explosions?
To make it more realistic. They gotta blow up the bus. This is Speed with Keanu Reeves.
You don't need explosives if a tornado can kill you with a piece of grass.
It's a fake tornado.
But it's supposed to feel real. You can crank up the tornado juice all you want.
I was gonna say, those AR drones don't really...
I'm Franz, and we have to crank
you up.
Crank up the tornado juice.
I'm about to crank up your tornado juice.
Well, because, like, there's not really a limit to the... To the VR, or the VR, the AR drone. So, I mean, they could just, like, crank it up.
You know, they could just shoot a man.
They could just shoot a man.
They got bullets.
Or you could just not go.
Also,
that far.
Thing about like creating an army is like probably since it's like 2023.
Here's my are they doing actual damage to property?
Yes, they are.
Okay, I was about to say if it's all like
back,
if it's all just like fake.
Well, no.
Are
so
they really doing anything illegal?
The drones.
If nothing's broken.
The drones are so well because I'm telling you, it's like the Incredibles when he goes and fights the big. He fights his own invention. And, like, destroys the city and stuff, and then he comes in and, like, just presses some stuff, and so things fall out.
Dude, are you suggesting that Spider-Man Far From Home is just a ripoff of The Incredibles?
Well, I mean, it's not a ripoff, but, I mean, like, it took ideas from it.
Everything is a ripoff.
I was gonna say, like...
He died.
He knows, he's just like, man.
Hello, my name is Peter Parker.
What is the point of that parachute that is here? Not doing anything?
It's to slow you down.
I guess a little bit. But he also has like a little bit. He has like a little glider.
Question.
Oh, I love how they detect his code and message.
You mentioned when spiders fall, they don't die, right?
Yes.
Do you think Spider-Man has the same ability?
But that happens because of the eight legs that create wind resistance. He doesn't have eight legs.
But he has two big legs and two arms. Which each has five fingers on each hand.
That's
so that's like
stupid.
10 limbs.
Yeah. 10.
You got 10 limb?
It's 10 limb.
It's not true. And those flaps are more similar to a squirrel than a spider, I have to say. That's
awesome. Should I call them flying squirrel man?
There's already Squirrel Girl. We don't need more squirrel theme.
Are you hating on Squirrel Girl right
yes.
now?
You hating on Jeanette? Sorry, she's a chipmunk. Shut up.
He already noticed his air. Shut up.
Don't you dare.
Don't even. Don't even.
Don't you
like,
even.
I'm telling you right now that don't you dare. Don't you dare do that.
So I'm
okay?
gonna tell you today that this is not vegan, and I don't even watch it. Don't even think it. Like, yas, queen. Don't even think it.
Oh boy.
I'm gonna kill him.
like go home and watch
Tony
Rocky.
Tony didn't buy me my cinnamon rolls, and I am so not having it.
Dude, I love cinnamon rolls. Honestly. I love banana bread.
I love cinnamon rolls, Tony. Please get me one with your money.
Is that what Pepper Pot said? Please get me cinnamon rolls. Please.
I am only in here for the money, Tony. Cinnamon rolls.
You got me.
Oh, I love that. Oh, that's so awesome.
Dude.
And he doesn't even flinch. Oh, that's the best.
Dude, Samuel awesome. Jackson is so awesome.
He is. He is.
I'm a huge Samuel Jackson fan.
I have to say I am too.
He deserves at least
I haven't
21
seen
Oscars
yet, though.
Me neither. I know, like, one scene.
I know the one where they're, like, dancing and the one where he eats a cheeseburger.
I know it's the dancing scene with, like, Uma Thurman and John Travolta.
Yeah. I had to, for an assignment, had to create a movie poster for a historical figure. And I chose a guy named Du Bois.
Du Bois?
You heard
of him?
If he's French, I think it's Du Bois.
Okay,
well, I was thinking Du Bois.
I remember looking at the pronunciation, and it was pronounced Du Bois.
It might be
like Boise, Idaho?
Is the historical figure, like, is he... You know, like, nationality is?
He was an African-American historical figure.
Oh, he's,
He was a civil rights movement person.
He's W.E.B.
Yes.
Du Bois, or Du Bois. I think it's Du Bois, actually.
Yeah, Du Bois. You pronounce the S. Well, anyway, I made a poster for it that was super cinematic, and I had to cast a main person, and I was like, Samuel L. Jackson should do this. And I was thinking... like, the reason Samuel L. Jackson hasn't won an Oscar is because he hasn't really gotten a role that has that acting difficulty to it.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't have something he's performed in that's required the range of him that he has. So I wonder what it would have happened if he did.
I don't know, man. Some of those movies he was in from Quentin Tarantino.
Well, yeah, but, like, I feel like his Quentin Tarantino days are kind of, like, over.
I don't think they are.
You think he's gonna come back? I bet he's gonna. If he is, he's gonna be like one.
Quentin
more.
Tarantino has one movie left in him,
really?
At least.
Oh, I thought he said that.
Well,
like, I
no,
only one
he
movie
did.
Left.
He said he was only gonna make 10 movies.
Wow,
that's kind of.
And
weird.
Then he was gonna move on to like other things.
Oh, isn't that? That's kind of like a. Isn't that? Is he like doing it for like purposes, or he's just like I just want to like retire, or he's like
I don't know.
I'm too cool for you guys. I'm gonna make 10.
I
and
think
that's
it's
it.
More of just
it's,
like a, I'm gonna do 10 and then I'm like
you're just
gonna
done.
Do like right. I think he's gonna do right.
I'd rather do
10
really good movies than a bunch of less good movies.
Yeah,
I think
that's his whole thing.
I
and
would
so,
say something similar, except I can't imagine only doing 10. I want to do way more than 10.
I think Once Upon a Time in Hollywood was his 9th.
Oh, so we only got one left. See, this last one...
I mean, unless he changes his mind,
this last
to make
one
more.
Is Samuel Jackson's bid for the Oscars.
I see you.
He just has to be in it, is the thing.
Stop filming your own death.
Dude,
oh,
I cannot
shit.
Tell you how many times Quentin
Tarantino... I love this! Yeah. How does Cap do that?
How does Cap do that?
Oh, so good.
Man, I love that.
Quentin Tarantino has died in his own movies like 3 times, at least.
Didn't he like?
You know, they say a cat has 9 lives. Say something, please. Did I call him a cat?
Yes, you did.
Okay, that's great.
I like. Me and my friends were talking one time when playing. I forgot what we were playing, but we were just chilling out on a party.
Are they with the Crown?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh!
They're in like
they
the
are.
Crown. Yeah, they're in the Crown Jewels.
Whoa! What a tourism opportunity.
Yeah. But.
Here's a picture of me next to the crown jewels.
I'm about
here's
to...
me narrowly escaping death.
Here's me. Here's
I'm about
me with a mace.
Shot up by a Marvel superhero villain.
A Marvel superhero villain.
Wait a minute.
the Freudian slip got me.
He's burning. His suit is on fire.
He's on fire.
He's Knight Rider.
Oh, and he got.
He's Knight Rider.
No, sorry, Ghost Rider.
And he just hit his back on the suspension.
Oh man, that
Don't worry,
second Ghost
fine.
Rider movie. Kind of sucked in comparison
I've,
to the first
I've
one.
Nick Cage himself has said they sucked.
The first one was actually
Nick
somewhat
Cage
okay.
Has to say a lot.
Wes Bentley was in the first
How
one.
How is Nick Cage still getting, like, acting opportunities?
I don't know.
Like,
I,
he got a new, like, Netflix special.
He
I don't know
is
why.
One of my mom's favorite actors.
I think he's one
know,
of my
right?
grandma's favorite
why?
Actors.
I don't know. Because he's got that deep voice, and he's kind of attractive.
Is he attractive?
He's got a nice voice, I guess.
I don't think just the voice
is
makes...
Is he attractive?
I guess...
I think
voice
he's been
can...
in some good movies.
Oh,
And maybe
Spider-Man
that's part
survived
of
that.
Yes, because really? He has superpowers.
What good movie is other than National Treasure? What good movie is Nick Cage?
I've heard that Con Air is good.
National Treasure.
That's why I said it's like because I know National Treasure. Like Sean Bean makes that movie good.
Sean Bean. Dude, I finished the first season of Game of Thrones.
I want Sean Bean to be in more stuff. Great. No way. But I feel like he's too humble for that because he just seems like a nice dude.
Have you ever seen Equilibrium? He is like a martyr at the beginning of that movie.
Really?
And he does a really good job. Yeah, Equilibrium is one of those movies that tried to be The Matrix with its special effects.
Is that the one with Christian Bale?
That's the one that's like on the cover, it was like, this is not The Matrix, it's Equilibrium.
No, they were like, I think on the cover it says, forget The Matrix.
Oh yeah, forget The Matrix, that's it.
Well, I like that movie just because like the acting and the story is really good. It's just the special effects that ruin it.
Well,
because
that's
cause it looks stupid.
It's like Christian Bale's like, or it's like not his attempt, but like it's an off-brand Matrix basically of
yeah.
Christian Bale, which is kind of
that
funny.
Movie almost made me cry. It was so good at some points. Like there was like a really intense
oh,
death
dude,
of the person.
We just
loves.
Missed one of my favorite lines from this whole
oh,
movie.
Oh yeah, I'm in love with Spider-Man's aunt. I thought we were all just confessing things.
Oh my gosh.
You know something?
You know that's a real place and a real sign, right? Has he got a camera?
Yeah, he does.
Oh, that's so sick.
You know what I just realized?
Yeah.
He's basically recreated the scene from Endgame where Captain America
that
has his shield. And Mjolnir at the same
oh,
time.
Oh yeah, and yeah. The Avengers theme just like is super powerful.
Very similar iconography.
Yes. Because he's got the whatever he was holding in the one hand, and he was like just flinging it around.
Yeah.
And then he's got the sign.
They somehow found a way to make a green screen suit look cool.
I was gonna say, like on his shoulders, he has like little triforces on there. He's got like a big triforce and
like,
small triforces.
Like that is very fashionable.
Casually walks over. Now can I have them, please?
I like how in the end he calls it. I think he calls it Peter Tingle.
Come on, Peter Tingle. Peter
Tingle. Tingle. Tingle.
Oh, that is so awesome.
Dude, I haven't seen a lot of these movies, but there's like a lot of like really cool like.
Oh, it's so
and
awesome.
And like all of like five like Marvel movies I've seen. There's so many like cinematic and also just like. Really cool
it's
like, comic book moments.
We're in the age where CGI has finally gotten to be truly good.
It's true. I feel like, but we only go like up from here is the thing. Like, and also just like eventually we may have like, I don't think like near this, but like we may have like some form of augment, like a better form of augmented reality.
I don't know what I'm gonna do when movies stop being this, because I don't think I can direct 3D movies. Well, I'll learn with the times, but augmented reality movies, VR movies, it entirely eliminates cinematography from the mix. So what?
Oh, yeah.
You're going to be just focusing on acting and
I mean,
set design and all those elements.
That's like what, like as a species, that's what like we're really known for doing is adapting.
Yeah.
Like just, like some, like back in like
I don't
thousands
think this
of
type
years
of
movie
is going to disappear though.
Oh yeah, definitely not.
Where they pick the shots for you instead of you being in the space to look around.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You do deserve that.
This is like
oh yep,
coolest
gotcha.
Scene.
Do you notice they dilated his pupils?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
You can't trick me anymore.
Like Batman's, it just breaks his wrist.
Oh, the glasses were my last strength. The source of my life.
I'm nothing without the glasses.
The source is my line.
My bones are now...
It kind of felt like when he took the glasses off...
Jelly.
When he took the glasses off, it kind of felt like with Sauron with the ring. He takes the ring off and then he just goes... Ugh, and it just kind of fades away. Yeah.
I am no man. That's the only, like... not subtle feminism in that movie, and they pulled it off, I have to say.
What?
How could you do all this?
Oh, well.
Well, because,
a
like,
lot of movies have an issue when they do feminist themes. They overdo it instead of making
it
subtle.
I feel like in that regard, Peter Jackson was like, ahead of the times, where he wasn't like overly like.
Like, I don't feel like that one was like too preachy. I feel like he pulled off a good character.
Well, that one was like, it's not like catering to anyone. It's like, this is a cool woman. Cool things are happening.
Yeah, like she's an actual character that's been developed like and a not real just person like, instead of a feminist icon.
Yeah, like they're not catering to anyone when
I like real people.
I do like real people.
I don't like agendas on screen.
Well, on screen. I was like, everyone has their own agenda, even though they say, I have no agenda.
I don't like on screen representations of agenda in my movies.
Oh, yeah. I like stuff that feels like. In its like character or like it's something that's not outlandish.
Okay, that's the word. I don't like tokenism.
Yeah, tokenism. Yeah,
I not get tokenism. Yeah, I love tokenism.
Is
I
awesome.
Don't like tokenism.
Tokenism is. I don't know. Okay.
Except okay? I danced with Zac Efron in the sky.
In the sky. I mean, he does. I also had
like
hair
Hugh Jackman was there. And then, like,
no, he wasn't
Hugh Jackman.
Well, he wasn't in. He wasn't
in the
dancing
movie.
With them. But he
no,
was.
That would have been weird.
What about if, like
Hugh
randomly,
Jackman third wheel in the whole thing? What
about,
like,
what about if randomly in that movie, like he just like pulled out his Wolverine claws?
I see, my friend. You wanna cut me in?
Anyway,
I used to have that song memorized. I knew how to perform that song.
Do you guys really like that movie? Works
for you? Oh, yeah, I like it. I don't like the historical figure it was based off of. I feel like it's weird that it exists at all.
They kind of morphed him into a not real.
They made him into a good person,
which in real life he wasn't. He was kind of a,
which is kind of dishonorable, but
yeah, making a kind of bad person into like a
an icon.
Yeah,
yeah. I like the movie.
But also,
just,
like,
it's weird that it exists.
The childish nature of it, where they're, like, singing, and they're like, yeah, we're away from the world, but then it's just like, no, this is a real figure.
This is a real person, and he was a pretty awful, awful person. Why does this movie exist?
For fun.
Oh, yeah, Dale.
Some writer was like, he's,
I'm good guy now.
Talking about music, Dale, how did you like, I forgot to ask you, how did you like Whiplash?
I actually like it better.
I thought it was pretty good.
That was pretty good.
My mom didn't like it.
I need to watch.
I really like.
I need to watch La La Land again.
Dude, La La Land.
Because that is one of
the. It's the same director.
Too. It's one of the most successful on-screen musicals of all time.
Mm-hmm. I just don't. I'm not a huge fan.
Okay, this one's a lot less cute than the first one.
See, La La Land. There's like, I can see why people don't like. There's the group of people that are just like, I don't like it. I'm like, okay.
I remember liking it when I watched it, but
it was really like, I think it was like
it was very artsy fartsy.
It was like one of my like favorite movies of like 2016.
Like, and it had a really cool concept of the ending where she like sees what her life would have been if she had stayed with him.
Which that's also a thing they do in Whiplash, where like the director does a lot of camera pans where like there's a scene in Whiplash where she's like dancing and stuff, and then like the dude's like on the piano going like this, and they have to do
really that's like exactly like La La Land.
No, that is La La Land.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, because
no,
like,
yeah, that is.
I was like, that's not in Whiplash.
No, that actually is in Whiplash, where he's like but up but up but up, and then he goes to Terrence Fletcher, and then he's like going like this and like doing all things where he's like pointing and stuff.
Something
and
very
back.
Emotionally raw and powerful about showing two sides of a decision when it's too late.
Yeah,
the
it,
one
it
part
good.
That I didn't like about Whiplash was the consistent amount of time. That he would say, not my tempo.
Oh, dude, that's
not my tempo.
That's my one of my favorite parts about it, where he's just like, are you rushing or are you dragging? And he's just like, so
dude,
his work is consuming him, and that's kind of the thing that like ends with.
Freaking loved the trombone scene.
Oh, yeah.
When he yells at the trombone, dude.
There's not a Big Mac down there.
Yes.
He's like staring.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
And then like the dude leaves, and he's like, by the way, it wasn't him. It was you!
Yeah, he's like, it was him.
I ship
But he didn't know, and that's just as bad.
I ship them.
Also, so this is like one of my favorite. I have a lot of favorite scenes in this movie, I just realized.
Oh, and they're not.
So, like their relationship, that's kind of, it's kind of cringy and meh. But then, like, when you see, like, Zendaya and, like, Peter Parker and MJ get together, they're kind of, it's more like, because like they're both really shy, and they're like, yeah, you know, like the whole time I was just like watching you because I really like you and stuff, and it's just, It gives you a good feeling.
Another reason that I hate couples like Ned and what's her face is because of that moment where you like mention
it's the part where his freaking parents don't show up to get him.
Yes,
it's actually kind of sad.
It's so mean spirited. What I was saying was the couples that have been together for like 2 weeks and you like bring something up about them and they're like, oh, you didn't know. We broke up. And I was like, oh, I didn't know. How dare I? Jeez. I've known you together for years. How dare I not pay attention? The heartbreak!
The pain!
Are you dating? I actually do that to them. I should sometime just so I feel better.
You should, like go into full actor mode where you go the suffering and like go into full Shakespearean just like kind of, I must not.
That's what they do sometimes though. Like I've known her for my entire life, not counting what was before that. I don't even remember what was before that.
I didn't have a life before
love
her.
Is such sweet sorrow. I will take my own life with this really old cheese. Then you will see what it is like without her.
I dare shall not stay in this life any longer.
This mortal realm traps me.
My existence is only an idea about existence.
I'm going to go Star Trek on the throne. Existence is futile.
I had the thought of saying that, but what she actually says is resistance is futile. I didn't want to be that guy.
Oh, yeah.
Which you are now.
What, Star Trek?
You misquoted 7 of 9.
Oh, I said existence. So I
he said existence is futile. It's resistance is futile.
I am fully aware it's resistance.
Well, yeah, because we were making fun
of
that.
It.
Yeah, but...
But it's disrespectful to say otherwise.
Gotcha, I guess? Oh my goodness.
Well, guess I'll die.
Well, guess I'll die.
Guess I'll die.
I've been cancelled.
Oh my goodness. You know, I think it was MatPat who talked about the physics of this. Since she's a normal person... Moving at this speed, slowing up and speeding down, her internal organs are going to be absolutely destroyed by the forces.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
He just killed his girlfriend at the end of this movie.
He's a menace! He's a menace, and we're about to see him! Be called a menace!
Are you excited?
I am excited. I knew I was going to be late today, and I was like, oh, I just got to end the movie here. And I was like, oh, there's probably an ending scene.
Desposito.
Is that Winston Churchill?
What?
Me and my dad watched this in theaters, and we were like, nope, we're waiting through the credits.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I always do. I always wait for the credits.
Marvel movies always have a special thing, and we were really excited about this one.
You know they did that at end of Mandalorian Season 2? They did, like, a thing where you had to wait all the way through the credits.
Oh, yeah.
It's an extra scene.
For Boba?
Yeah, for Boba.
I love Boba.
That's good season 2.
I really need to watch that.
I mean, so... I
honestly think that you would like it.
The Mandalorian is the best thing to come out of Star Wars, hands down. Like, it's really good.
I keep getting, See, Zendaya! No last name!
No last name.
Mandalorian is probably the most common thing requested of me to see in general, let alone on the show.
What? What'd you say? Oh, on the show, yeah.
Yeah, I've had people ask for Mandalorian now that we've done Star Wars. I'm just all Star Wars out for at least this... couple years.
Wait, can we turn the volume up a little bit?
What song is it?
This song was in Alvin and the Chipmunk Shipwrecked.
It was.
Why do you remember that?
Because I loved that movie!
And you know what's sad?
What?
When I heard that song, that's immediately what I thought of. Because Shipwrecked used to be the one to watch. Like, I wouldn't watch the first or second one that much. It was Shipwrecked.
You guys need to watch more movies.
That was the good one. I was a kid.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can handle watching that one in the
I had to
now.
Watch it a lot more recently because my baby cousin loves it.
Whenever I think of an Alvin and the Chipmunks song, I automatically think of Cause You Had a Bad Day, You Take It One Down.
Oh, I always, from the first one, I always really liked the Christmas song.
She's so dead. Oh, that impact.
Ooh.
I don't want Zendaya to die. Please, no, next movie.
I mean, she's talking.
Never.
Dude, well, they're gonna pull an Andrew Garfield.
It takes a bit of time to internally hemorrhage, Ben.
I guess.
She's about to die.
Just squish all the lungs in.
It's like how the Grinch dies immediately after the credits close because of his cardiac arrest.
Wait, what?
Yeah, you know how his heart increases by 3 sizes?
Yeah.
And he, like, has that huge moment of pain before that moment of warmth? That is very reminiscent of cardiac arrest. Okay, let's watch this.
The Grinch had a heart attack.
I can barely hear. He has an army weaponized drone, Stark technology. He's saying he's the only one who's gonna be the new Iron Man, no one else.
Are you sure you want to commence the drone attack?
Oh.
There will be significant casualties.
Do it! Execute them all!
Oh my goodness.
The shocking video was released earlier today on the controversial news website, the Daily Bugle.
No one thinks it's...
Oh my goodness, it's Terrence Fletcher.
Dude, he was J. Jonah Jameson in the originals, too. Yep. He was great.
Oh yeah, you haven't seen the Tobey Maguire, so you're not even...
I've seen, like, the screenshots and, like, the scenes.
Ben?
What? What, you think I shouldn't have done that?
You just got half nostalgic for that moment.
Oh, yes.
You didn't even get to feel it.
I'm so outraged.
Oh my gosh.
You didn't even get to feel it properly. You need to feel it inside
you. MJ.
I also like
Zendaya.
How she has, like, the shortest name, NJ, Zendaya, like, all that kind of thing. Yeah. J.K. Simmons.
It's an interesting thing for a stage name.
Yep.
I've been thinking about stage names.
Of course, Venetian Glassblower, my favorite.
Like Zendaya sounds like the name of like a design brand. Like Zendaya. Like,
oh my
South
god,
clothing.
Is that Zendaya?
Well, no, yes,
really
Zendaya
good
style
on
clothing.
You.
Yes, these Zendaya shoes cost like $2,000. I had to sell my boyfriend's kidneys to get these Zendaya shoes. And oh my,
sell my
gosh,
boyfriend's
they are
kidneys.
So vegan.
You keep going with the bit. I'm gonna fact check something.
You're gonna
what?
Check.
I'm just like, no, the cost of a kidney.
It's enough for shoes.
It's actually quite a lot.
Yes. Yes.
I want to say it's somewhere around $25,000.
Shoes? Once in a lifetime? Boyfriend? Well, I can get way more.
I suppose it depends. Are you talking
I can
about,
just
like,
get another one.
Are you talking about legally, or are we talking like...
I can just
like,
get another boyfriend.
So black market buying someone's kidney.
So, in the you can legally sell your stuff. So your kid... So
sell your stuff!
So your kidney... So per
pull
kidney...
Pull out your kidney! Here's my stuff!
So it's 2,600...
Yes.
Or it's $262,000. Or two hundred. I think I'm saying that right.
Yes.
200,000.
$262,000.
$262,000.
Yeah. To sell one kidney.
Why are you adding an extra 100,000?
I don't know.
There between...
And then livers. Okay. Livers are $500,000.
Mm-hmm.
And a whole heart is $1,000,000.
I have a liver.
And you can legally sell this.
I have
yes.
a kidney. I also have a heart.
But like I think
that's a lot of money.
But I feel like if you lose
my whole boyfriend.
So you can live without one kidney. So you can just sell your kidney.
Doesn't your kidney like grow back?
I've never heard that before, but
no.
That sounds really fascinating.
Somebody told me that your kidney grows back and I was skeptical at first. I just wanted
some
to...
kid in the park, "Hey, you know your kidney grows back?"
Some
you
dude pulled up.
"Hey, okay, boyfriend, I'll just grow back."
But he's so vocal of him, he's going to die.
Don't worry, it'll be like 10 minutes tops.
Oh, now I get black market.
Do you want a kidney?
So
I
now it's saying on the black market.
Notice they have an individual cast for each country they filmed in.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Which is amazing.
Cheers, that... Gaffa.
Oh, best boy, Harry Gay.
Prodigy.
Oh, yeah.
That was his name.
So on the black market, it says it's
Harry
even
gay
less.
Is like my
than
boyfriend.
If you're
legally with gays. Oh, crap. Oh, no.
What?
I am so sorry, Henry Gays.
No, it's just Henry Gay.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, it's his real name.
I only started reading it because I never understood what best boy was.
Best boy? I never understood
not
what
not at all
that
making
is
fun of your name, even though we accidentally did.
Right. Yeah.
You mean.
I did not originally...
Oh my goodness, the Venus internet?
Viola?
Yeah.
Stunts?
So it's even saying on the black market it sells for less, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me.
Well, yeah.
But you know what? We're just going to go with it. You, as an American citizen, now are entitled to...
It's better to buy...
Financial compensation.
$62,000 to sell one kidney to anyone
yes,
right now.
Yes, those Zendaya shoes for like $200,000. And I like want a macchiato.
Wait, dude. what a scam you could pull, right?
Yeah.
You sell your kidney. You buy a kidney off the black market for cheaper, and you sell it again, legally.
Yes.
Yeah. For a higher amount of money.
You have to go through a lot of channels.
Yes.
I'm just saying. Yes. Hear me out.
Yes.
You buy a kidney. Yeah. You sell a kidney.
Yeah.
You buy another kidney.
Yeah.
You sell the same kidney again.
Do you guys want to close this video?
You rebuy your own kidney to sell it again.
Yeah. And by the end of it, you have a full can of kidney beans.
Yes. Thank you everybody for watching this episode of the Cinematic Fanatics. Please like and subscribe. Crap! I forgot about something. We'll take care of it next time. Bye.
Tony's Catering!
But Tony's Catering! I know Tony!